All right, we welcome you to Magness Arena here on the campus of Denver University. We're in Denver, Colorado tonight, and it is game one of the NCHC quarterfinals playoffs. And the postseason are finally here. The Miami RedHawks, the 8th seed in the NCHC tournament, taking on the number one seed and defending national champion Denver Pioneers. Patrick Geshan with you high above the ice here inside Magness Arena. So glad you are with us on this Friday evening. Really appreciate you spending a part of your Friday evening with us. It is a Red Hawk Pioneer matchup for year number two in the quarterfinals of the NCHC playoffs. These two teams saw each other for a short two-game series last year in this building. The Pioneers took care of the Red Hawks with a two-game sweep that weekend. 5-2 was the score on Friday, 5-1 the score on Saturday. Of course, the Red Hawks look to turn their fortunes around against the Pioneers, not only after that series last season, but also in general. Denver's won 10 straight meetings between these two teams, and the Pioneers swept the Red Hawks here in January, the middle part of the month of January. The games January 13th and 14th here at Magness Arena. The Pioneers sweeping Miami with a score of 7-0 on Friday and 7-0 on Saturday. Mentioned the Pioneers have won 10 straight in the series. That's the longest winning streak the Pioneers have had against the Red Hawks in their all-time series. Last Red Hawk win here was on February 22nd, 2019. And they will try to take care of business here in the quarterfinals of the NCHC and try to keep their season going past this weekend against the number third ranked team in the nation, Denver Pioneers, who are also the defending national champion. And of course, mentioned all their postseason success last year. This year, they're looking to become a contender in the Frozen Four and for the national title as well. They certainly have the capable group and veteran lineup to do so. Teams are taking the ice here inside Magness Arena. We'll get to your starting lineups in just a moment. The Pioneers are without their big-time starting netminder tonight in Magnus Corona. They are also without a couple of top scorers. Their top scorer is on the lineup tonight in Massimo Rizzo. And we also got some late word tonight that a big scratch for the Pioneers is out as well in Sean Behrens. He's been a top guy back on the defensive end for the Pioneers this season. So has Jared Wright. He is not in the lineup as well either. So it's a Pioneer team that's without some of their top weapons, a Red Hawk team that's without some weapons as well, and we'll talk about that as the night goes on. But first, let's check in with the public address here inside Magness Arena for tonight's starting lineups.
Number 17, Geshan.
Starting lineup tonight before the Pioneers and the RedHawks. Plus your national anthem, game one of our NCHC quarterfinals this weekend from Magness Arena. All right, time for tonight's starting goaltenders. We start with the visiting RedHawks, Ludvig Pearson in their net. The junior from Hedda, Sweden, 6'1", 184. It'll be his 30th start of the season, 31st appearance, 8-17-4 record on the year for Ludvig, 3.46 goals against, 897 save percentage. For the reigning NCHC goaltender in the month of February. No Magnus Krona tonight, the veteran, wonderful, outstanding starting goaltender for the Pioneers this season. It's gonna be Matt Davis. Krona is nursing a foot injury, we're told. So Davis stands at 6'1", 193. He's a sophomore from Calgary, 6'1-0 on the year, 1.72 goals against, and a 923 save percentage for Davis, who has a shutout on the season. So Davis, the heir apparent to Magnus Krona in the net. Again, Krona's injured, but he still has some really good numbers on the year. RedHawks are in their road reds. Miami across the front in white with a white number below it. White name, white number on the back for the RedHawks in their red helmets this evening. Pioneers go with the home whites. Denver across the front in maroon, a maroon number below it. Maroon name, maroon number on the back, and maroon helmets for the Pioneers. RedHawks will move left to right across your radio here in the first period of play from Magnus Arena. Your referees tonight will come from the NCHC. They are Sterling Egan and Brian Hankins, linesman Eric Contino and John Grant. The opening faceoff won by the RedHawks, and the game is on here from Magnus Arena. So are the playoffs. Postseason's on already here at college hockey. And in the NCHC, Pioneers win the, of course, the RedHawks won the faceoff. Pioneers won the puck back in their own zone. It's playing behind the Denver net, or Davis will play it over the far half wall for his defenseman. That was Mike Benny who coughed up the puck, went to the far corner. Lee had it for a moment for Denver. Thompson has it, shoves it over on the far wing. Denver gets out back to center. Mazur with a cross corner dump into the far wing inside the RedHawks zone. Near circle with a torn box, sent it over on the far side. Thompson had a drive there, nice block down by Pearson. Far half wall now, Red Savage has got it for the RedHawks. He'll scan it through the neutral zone over the Pioneer line here on the left wing. He'll fire his shot, little wrister in, rim of the circle on the far half wall. And a nice save made there by Davis in the breadbasket as the RedHawks' first shot comes with 51 seconds gone by in the first, and we are scoreless. RedHawks flew to Denver on Wednesday. They were here yesterday, had a nice practice in the afternoon. The morning skate this morning, and now we're here playing game one of this best of three series. Pioneers won the draw to the right of Davis. They'll break it out along the near wing, sent out back to center, a feed to really nobody there off the stick of Carter King. Puck will go in the RedHawks zone where Clement feeds to the near side below the goal line for Feenstra. He'll send it up right wing. Dukovac throws it over the Pioneer line on the right side of the near corner. Kyle Mayhew first to the puck there for Denver. He'll try to play it up near half wall. RedHawks though with a nice forecheck take the puck away in the offensive zone. Back in the net, Fletcher centers it high slot with a drive there by Clement, and a nice glove save was made by Davis. Really good look there to Jack Clement with a feed that came from below the goal line by Fletcher, get deflected and route to the captain. But he fired it just above the rim of that circle, the top of the circles in the middle of the ice. Nice slap shot there on a one-time look and a good glove save just off the right post by Davis. Sophomore from Calgary, played USHL hockey with Green Bay and the Gamblers. The sophomore understudy of Magnus Krona this season in the Pioneer net. Far half wall lead with a face-off win for the Pioneers in the far circle of their own zone. He'll chip it out back to center. Pioneers over the Red Hawk line on the right wing. Edwards did that, and then a Miami clearing attempt to try to get it back up the ice out of their zone, goes into the Red Hawk bench on the far side up the left wing. That was Chase Pletsky who threw it in. Just trying to get it out of danger, and the neutral zone faceoff will take place on the Red Hawk left wing, closest to their blue line, with 18:29 to go in the first. No score between the Red Hawks and the Pioneers. Pass to Capone in his faceoff. Capone wins it back for Denver to the right point. Benning will rim this one deep into the Pioneers zone of the left wing. Edwards in the near corner working to try to dig it free for Denver. He will. Back to the line for Lee, left point. And go to the near corner to feed the deflected wide of a Pioneer stick. Chipped off the glass and back out of play by Axel Kuhlman. I think it maybe went off the stick of Ryan Savage as it bounced out over the glass near the Red Hawk line at that end of the ice along the near wing. And so with 18:11 to go in the first, draw will go to the right of Ludwig Pearson in the Red Hawk net in a scoreless affair. Faceoff will feature the Pioneers, Ina Thompson against the Red Hawks. Red Savage has put together a pretty decent stretch as of late. Red has 3 goals in his last 3 games. Pioneers win the faceoff back to the left point, shoveled down for the left point to the near corner by Casey Dornbach. Goes up the near half wall to Carter Mazur for Denver. Feeds it back to the line. Benning, center point, rips a shot off the near post. Rebound in front is whacked wide of the net off the stick of Thompson. Really good shot there from the line, but it hit off the near post. Pearson never got his left leg to stretch out and grab it. Red Hawks to the puck back at center. Barbellini, a backhand whack of the puck. Goes behind the Pioneer net. Denver will try to break out from there. Red Hawks steal it away on a forecheck. Far half wall, Waldron went. Got it back to Barbellini. Pioneers don't work it back out of their zone. Mazur's got it. There's center ice. He'll backhand to the near wing in the Red Hawk zone where Jack Clement will get it, and the Pioneers in a full 5-man change. Near wing it goes to Alex Murray up the right wing. He got hit hard there by the Pioneer player, and Haskins are able to get it into the Pioneer zone. Sent out of there by the Denver's Kyle Mayhew. He'll take the puck now through center ice over the Red Hawk line on the right wing. Then it was stuck away back to center ice. And the Pioneers have to regroup back in their own zone. Olvestad feeds left wing over the Red Hawk line. Tristan Lemire, he got tripped up coming through the near circle. Murray let him go. That will not be a call. We'll play on. Pioneers get the puck here up to the near point. Near side is Olvestad. He'll fire wrist to in. Nice pat save made by Pearson. Pioneers work this one back out on the rebound near the line. With a puck here, Lemire hits the brakes at the near point. Walks his way middle. Over on the right side now is Olvestad. He'll backhand this one to the far corner. We're battling for it there is Lemire. He will try to work it here on the far post. Murray providing great body position there to try to knock the puck away. Ozar with it here near half wall. Goes back to the right point. Shot there, Olvestad, and ice. Love save was made by Pearson on the soft wrister off the left-handed stick. You have 16:25 to go in the first. And no score between Miami and Denver. The shots 4-2 Pioneers early on in this one. Great stretch of play there by Denver, working the puck forward in the offensive zone. The best puck possession that the Pioneers have had at that end of the ice in the first 3.5 minutes or so of the game. And that one shot that came from the line off the stick, I believe, of Benning that rattled off the iron, never rattled Pearson. Red Hawks win the draw in their own zone. Dukovac feeds far wing. Rehnquist over the Pioneer line. Will try to feed it middle. That one broken up to Cassetti. Dukovac far circle. Feeds it back to the point. Fletcher a drive. They score! P.J. Fletcher from the right point. Got a one-timer from Kuhlman. And the Red Hawks drop first blind at 16:08 to go in the first. P.J. Fletcher launches the one-timer past the Denver net miner and Matt Davis. And the Red Hawks take the 1-0 lead on what is P.J. Fletcher's 5th goal of the year and 15th point of the season. Red Hawks got that puck deep in the Pioneer zone and went back to the left point where Kuhlman went D-to-D to the right point for Fletcher. And he was on the off wing, the left-handed player from the right side with a one-timer there that went past the outstretched right leg of the netminder in Davis. Beautiful drive from Fletcher, who had a good chance earlier on in the game as well. And a 1-0 Red Hawk lead, 16:08 to go in the first. And that goal will come at 3:52 of the opening period. Fletcher at even strength. Kuhlman and Dukovac will grab the assist there for the Red Hawks, who drop first blood. By the way, the first goal the Red Hawks have scored in their 3rd game of the year here at Magness Arena. They were shut out the first two. Pioneers with a face-off win here in the offensive zone. Shai Buiam sends it to the middle from the left point. Now get broken up off a Red Hawk stick. And Ryan Savage trying to chip this one back up the wing from the near half wall. Couldn't get it out on the clear. Pioneer shovel this one back to the near corner of the Red Hawk zone. And the puck there is Brett Edwards. Back to the line for Buiam. Whacks his way to the high slot from the line. The shot pierces the sand. They crash for the rebound. It's whacked out to the right point where Bennett keeps it in the zone. He'll fire over on the far wing with a puck there, Buiam. He'll rip a shot from the top of the far circle. Edwards kicked it away with a stick to the far corner. He'll pick it back up for Denver, get it to the center point where a shot there. They get deflected off the leg of Dylan Moulton. Ryan Savage picks it up. He'll get to the red line at center ice on the right wing and fling it in behind the Denver net. Back in the net there was Davis as the Red Hawks in a change. Pioneers turn it over, trying to work it through the middle. The Waldrick got the puck left wing after coming off the bench in a change. He'll take it over the Pioneer line here on the left wing in the far corner where it's quickly grabbed there by Buiam. Far corner, Walder trying to work for the puck in a battle there up against Matt Benning. Waldron's going to win it. Walked his way to the goal line. Far side of the net. You get a little pass there and it gets deflected away into the middle. Barbalina now will whack it toward the net from the far circle. Red Savage couldn't get a stick on that puck. Biner's trying to clear it up the right wing. They will. A 2-on-2 the other way. Haskins goes left wing. Ozar dumps it over the Red Hawk line in the near corner of the Miami zone. As Denver getting a few changes here. Feenstra gets it for the Red Hawks. Lifts it up left wing, back out center ice. Waldrick dumps it from the center ice red line, left wing, back in the Pioneer net and around the boards. Davis there, back of his net for Denver. Sends it over on the far wing. Doran Bach off the boards, back in the Red Hawk zone. And Miami with it through center ice. Dukovac over the Pioneer line right side. Cassetti is shot in the near circle. Nice left kick save was made there by Davis. Near corner now, Dukovac trying to work it out for the Red Hawks. Goes back to the right point. Kuhlman sends it wide of the Pioneer net. Mazur will pick up the rebound from there on the far half wall, lifted out back to center. Mayhew takes it over the Red Hawk line here on the left wing. Near circle, he's got it dancing toward the net. Got a penalty coming here on the Red Hawks, and then Kuhlman hooked him. And the Pioneers will go to the power play. They get the extra guy on with a delayed call. Mazur walks to the corner, back of the Red Hawk net. Cassetti locked him up against the boards, but the Fiend got to Devine. He will throw it back to the line. Shot there, Olvestad. Went off the shoulder of Rehnquist over the far half wall in the Red Hawk zone. Touched up there by Axel Kuhlman. It'll be a slashing call to Miami with 13:24 to go in the first. And it's not Kuhlman who's going to get it. Instead, it is PJ Fletcher for the Red Hawks as Miami will try to protect their 1-0 lead on the penalty kill when we come back. Two for slashing against Fletcher, and the Pioneers power play goes to work for the first time tonight when we return to Magness. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Miami and Denver, 8:03 to go in the opening period on a Friday night from the Rocky Mountains. NCHC quarterfinal game one. Center ice faceoff under a timeout. Cassetti will take it against Denver's Carter King, and King will win the center ice drop back in his own zone. Goes to the left wing for Shane Bouilliam. He'll feed it over on the right side for Benning. He'll try to whack this one through center, but cannot. Rehnquist batted down that pass attempt and put it deep in the Pioneer zone. Bouilliam back to get it. Left wing feed went off the stick of King. It'll go to Bros, though. He'll skate it over the Red Hawk line. Left wing drop pass to Vine. Through the circle, a nifty toe drag on Fletcher. And he fired a wrister at the near faceoff dot in the Red Hawk zone, but Pearson was ready with a glove save to stop the near post of the net. Good movement there by the Pioneers up the sheet. Toe drag there, Bros and his teammate and Devine were working. Remember, Devine scored that one Denver goal early on in the period. Toe drag on Fletcher, topped the near circle and fired in. A nice glove save, Pearson on the wrister. Pioneers win the draw to the near side of Pearson in the Red Hawk zone. Goes back to the Miami net on a Red Hawk win. Red Savage left wing feed of Barbellini. It missed his stick a few inches above it. And then we'll go all the way down the ice for an icing. That'll come with 7:22 to go on the first on the icing call against the Red Hawks in a 1-1 game. Miami team that is not qualified for the frozen faceoff, meaning next weekend, the final four of the NCHC tournament since they won the thing back in 2014-15. So when the Red Hawks beat St. Cloud 3-2 in the championship, we got a puck out of play here. Red Hawks won the faceoff on the near side of Pearson. Barbellini lifted it out of play, trying to go off the glass, went over the glass, up the left wing after a Red Hawk faceoff win, and so that'll put the faceoff again to the left of Ludvig Pearson in the Denver zone, or the Red Hawk zone rather, with 7:15 to go in the first. The Denver offensive zone, I should say. Red Savage and Denver's Connor Capone. Capone wins the draw back to the center of the point. Benning a drive there. Pearson, nice left pad save. Pioneers work it back at the blue line where a shot that went wide there from Edwards off his left-handed stick to the near corner. Bouilliam trying to work on it there. Red Hawks get it up the near wing back to center ice. Waldron for Miami will lift it to the far side corner in the Denver zone where Benning will pick it up for the Pioneers. He will turn it over though at the left wing, trying to go to Pletsky. This one goes far side for Benning, and up the right wing is Capone. Feeds it middle now for Bouilliam. He has room to skate through the neutral zone over the Red Hawk line and dump it on the left wing. Pearson back of his net will stop it as the Pioneers get into a full five-man change. Olton with a puck near wing. Drasner up the right side for Ryan Savage. He'll flip it over the Pioneer line on the right wing and back of the Denver net. Stopped there by the net miner and Davis. Near corner now, the Pioneers will work it. Haskins up the left wing, Ozar over the Red Hawk line, right side, his feet over there for Moulton, or was picked off by Moulton, intended for Mayhew, who got the puck back in the far circle, walked it toward the net, and a nice little shot there, but a nice left pad save as well by Pearson on that shot by Mayhew, little wrister. Traster's got it with plenty of room in the Red Hawk zone. Up the left wing, he'll fire a feed to Ryan Savage, gets it middle, Pletsky near circle, a shot there, a nice block by Olmstead. Goes over on the far corner. Kuhlman will back in this one, trying to go to Daskus on a feed there. Mayhew took it away for Denver, and he'll flip it over the Red Hawk line on the right wing. Full five-man change for the Pioneers as Miami room to regroup in their own zone. Rehnquist around the boards to the far half wall. Fletcher puts it out to center ice. Lee will play it ahead up the left wing for the Pioneers. Devine over there for King over the Red Hawk line left side. Brohl's room to skate, got a feed in the near circle and flipped a weak shot over the net. Missed Pearson. Pioneers still control in their offensive zone. Center point set by Brohl's to the near corner. Working there, Devine trying to walk the goal line toward the net. Dukovac was in pestering him. Devine still the puck, walking it over to the far half wall. He'll be shoved away by Dukovac. Red Hawks won the puck for a second. Now on the stick of Brohl's. Goes for a slot feed there to Devine, and he scores! A shot that deflected over the left shoulder of Pearson. It took a really weird bounce. I don't know if it hit a stick or a skate, but Pearson lost that puck after Devine fired a really weak wrister in the slot. It popped up in the air, went over the left shoulder of Ludvig, and into the net. Ludvig never saw it. It deflected off the stick of Kuhlman in the slot. feed came from the far corner. Divine at the high slot, little shot that was on the ice, and then Kumla tipped it with a stick unintentionally. He was right there trying to defend Divine. Popped off the stick to the top far corner of the Red Hawk net, and Pearson after the tip had no idea where the puck was. Don't blame him at all. I wouldn't have found it either. Weird deflection. So the Pioneers have scored two unanswered. It's now a 2-1 game. They're on top here late in the first. As Divine with his second goal of the game. Back to the net, Pioneers with a puck in their own zone. Mazur chips it over the Red Hawk line left wing. Feenstra quickly chops it out back to center. Mazur back with a puck in his own zone for the Pioneers. Goes rink wide with it. For a feed there by Mayhew, they get broken up at center. Thompson grabbed it for a moment for Denver, and then back to Boehm, who's at center ice right on the red line. He'll back in this one from the stripe to the near corner of the Red Hawk zone. Feenstra's on it there. Up the near wing boards for John Waldron. Room to skate up the right wing at center. He'll go across corner, far wing of the Denver zone. On the dump in there, Pioneers quickly on it. Capone up the right wing through center ice. We'll give it up to Murray, the defenseman back for the Red Hawks, and they'll move it up on the right wing. Messenberg over the Pioneer line with a shot wide to the far side of the net on the ice. Kieran Giallo will put it to the near corner. Taranski trying to work there against Justin Lee of Denver in a one-on-one battle. It becomes a 2-on-2 square off as Messenberg joins the party, and so in there for Denver is Lucas Olmstead. And keep fighting for it, battling back at the Denver net now with 3:35 to go in the first. 2-1 Pioneer lead. Kieran Giallo won the battle, back to the right point. Murray, a little wrister there, and they get jammed up along the near post on a good save that was made by the netminder Davis. Molting it, blown up at center by Capone in a loose puck battle. Pioneers with it back in their own zone. Olmstead up the left wing, chipped there by Lorenz, back in the Red Hawk net in the Miami zone. Pearson turned it over almost, but it ended up on the stick of Molten from Denver pressure. Right wing now, Ryan Savage over the Pioneer line on the left wing. Far side, Pletsky trying to play it middle. That feed get deflected off Benning's left leg, went to the far corner in the Denver zone. Divine will pick it up there, drop it back of his own net. Where it goes up the near wing here for Benning, plays it off the glass, back to center ice. King, right wing feed, breakaway maybe Divine, but he was offside. Divine was cherry picking a little bit there. Away from Axel Kumlin. He got a nice feed from the front of the penalty boxes. Rink wide up the right wing, but jumping over the line before the puck came through was Divine. Easy call there for the linesman to make. And we have immediate timeout with 2:49 to go in period number one. A 2-1 Denver lead over Miami on the goal by Jack Divine late first. And this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. One Denver lead. We're back at Magness Arena. 2:49 to go in period number one. Patrick Geshan with you high above the ice. Okay crowd tonight inside Magness. It's not completely full, but pretty decent crowd and a good student crowd as well. Spring break next week for Denver University, but a lot of students staying back to watch their Pioneers at home for the last time this year. A puck set up the ice after a center ice faceoff out of our timeout. Dornbach put it all the way down the sheet. The icing was peed out by Denver's number 34 and Carter Mazur, but Ludwig Pearson got the puck and covered it up against the far post of his net as that puck came through. And so that number one negated the icing, number two stopped the play. And the faceoff is to his right with 2:38 to go in the first. It'll be Cassetti in the faceoff for the Red Hawks against Denver's number 7 in white. That's Enid Thompson. Thompson wins it between his legs, back to the left point for Mazur. He'll go right side now through the circle, walk it toward the net, trying to fire a shot, but it went back to the Red Hawk net, picked up his own puck right there. Mazur now in the far circle, still with the puck on his stick, feeds it over on the right point now for Boehm. He'll hand it off to Mayhew near the Red Hawk bench. Scanned at center point. Mayhew to the near circle. Room to work. And a nice shot there that are fought off by the right pad of Pearson. Went to the far corner. Pioneers work at Thompson. Backhand feed to the line. But Williams got it for the Pioneers at the far half wall. Trying to spin away from Dukovac, providing some staunch defense. But Williams still with it. Far corner. It poked off his stick there by Dukovac. Feenstra up the left wing with a puck to Seni. Right wing Dukovac will back in over the Pioneer line, back of the Denver net. Full five-man change for the Redhawks, 1:45 to go in the first in a 2-1 game. They trail to the Pioneers. Near wing Bros for Denver, takes it over the Redhawk line here on the left wing. Through the near circle, centers hit in front, nobody really home though for Denver. And Waldron still in the puck way for the Redhawks, room to skate over the Denver line on the right wing. He will feed it middle, nobody home there on that pass for the Redhawks. Bros takes over for Denver, back of the Pioneer net. Divine to the near half wall for Lee. That pass got almost picked off. Waldron ended up getting the loose puck after it deflected off the stick of that Denver player and King, who was in the area as well. Waldron fired a weak shot on the ice toward the net, and a nice save was made by the right pad with a cover as well from Matt Davis. Weak shot in there on the sheet by Waldron, and Davis made the easy right pad save and covered it up. 1:18 to go in the first, 2-1 Denver lead. The shots are 13-9, Pioneers. Faceoffs, 14-3 Denver. They've been dominant in the faceoff circle so far tonight. Daskus and Caponi on the draw to the left of the Denver netminder and Davis. Won by the Redhawks forward. Daskus picks it up back in the Denver net. Left point, Coleman, a laser shot there. Blocked down by his own man in front. And Pletsky just got nailed from behind into the boards by Caponi as they went for the loose puck after it deflected off Pletsky in front of the net on that shot by Coleman. Pletsky's already got up. He's skating off the ice, so that's great to see. I don't think he got that hit as badly as he could have, but Caponi just shoved him nastily from behind away from the boards. Along the end wall back in the Denver net, and I'm sure they're going to review it. Or I don't think they will. 2 minutes for cross-checking they call. Surprised they don't review it. Those from behind. Textbook from behind. Pletsky was about 3 feet off the boards. Caponi laid a nice shove on him as they were going after that loose puck after the shot by Coomlin deflected to the end boards back in the Denver net. Miami power play will go to work, and it will be the first chance they get tonight. They're in the offensive zone of the faceoff win with a minute to go in the first. At the goal line, near side is Barbolini trying to feed near circle. Red Savage's shot went back in the Denver net. Back of the line it goes. Rehnquist, a shot on the wrister there, left point. Through traffic, Davis saw it. He made the glove save to stop play with 49.4 seconds to go in the first. And the draw will be to his right with 1:44 to go on this power play. The 2 minute minor for cross-checking two, Denver's Connor Caponi. Miami power play this season, that is at 15.6%. That is the eighth best in the NCHC, also the worst in the conference. This one is a face-off win by the Redhawks, but it splits the defensemen at the line between Rehnquist and Red Savage. So Rehnquist will skate it out of his own zone for Miami and toss it back for Walder. Goes to the middle of the ice where Red Savage lost a hold of the puck, but it was able to get it over the Pioneer line on the right wing. Cassetti had it for a moment, but William was aggressive on him there and got the puck off Cassetti's stick, ripped it down the sheet. And with 20 seconds to go in the first, Redhawks with it back of their own net. Rehnquist up the near wing with 1:10 to go on the power play as well. Through center ice, will take it over the Pioneer line on the right side. And another take away there by the Pioneers. Ozar that time stolen away from Rehnquist. Put it in the Redhawks zone. Puck at center ice. Red Savage with a second to go in the period will take it over the line, and that'll be that for the opening 20 minutes of the NCHC playoffs for the Miami Redhawks and the Denver Pioneers in game one of this best of three series from Denver. 2-1 lead for the hometown team and the Pioneers after this 20 minutes of play. Denver goals coming tonight, both of them from number four in their uniform. Jack Devine, the sophomore from Glencoe, Illinois, product of the U.S. under 18 team with his 10th and 11th goals on the season tonight. First one came 7:38 into the first period from Devine. That's what made it a 1-1 game after PJ Fletcher got the scoring started for the Redhawks. 3:52 into the first, Redhawks struck early in that opening period. as Fletcher got his goal off a nice bounce in front. It was his fifth goal of the year, 15th point of the year for PJ Fletcher. Kumlin the assist on that with Dukovac. So that's what made it 1-0 RedHawks. 3:52 into the first period. Denver responded shortly thereafter, 7:38 into the opening frame as Jack Devine struck on the power play for his 10th goal of the season. The assist there to Casey Dornbach and Aiden Thompson. And then 15 minutes into the first period, an even strength, Jack Devine with a second Denver goal to make it 2-1. Tristan Brose and Carter King had the assists on that one for the Pioneers. And so that's where we stand here after our opening 20 minutes of play. A 2-1 Denver lead here from Magness Arena. And a pretty riled up Magness Arena as well. Mentioned it is spring break next week for Denver University, but still a lot of students here to watch their defending national champion Pioneers play and take the ice. The last time they'll get a chance to see them here in Denver this season at home inside Magness. Of course, Pioneer team that's probably going to make the NCAA tournament, so no matter what happens in the series this weekend, they're probably going to be playing at least 2 weeks from now at some regional somewhere in the NCAA tournament. Let's take a look at your NCHC scoreboard. Again, the first weekend of the playoffs in the NCHC, most of the other conferences are already in their playoffs. They started those last weekend, especially the leagues that have more than 10 teams or so, but the NCHC with 8 teams just does their quarterfinals on this weekend of the season, and then the Frozen Faceoff next weekend in St. Paul. Around the league tonight, Colorado College has a 3-1 advantage over Western Michigan. I would assume that game has gone final from Lawson. Not confirming that officially. Let me just get a second check on that here. But yeah, 3-1 Colorado College over the Western Michigan Broncos. That is a final. So the Broncos, who are the number 2 seed in the NCHC, have been upset tonight in game one of their best of three from Kalamazoo. The Colorado College Tigers win the first game of that series 3-1 at Lawson Ice Arena over the Broncos. So that's a huge big upset in the NCHC first round of the playoffs tonight. Big time as the Tigers take care of the Broncos. We have a 1-0 St. Cloud lead over Minnesota Duluth from the Brooks Center in St. Cloud tonight. That game is about halfway done, 9:27 to go in the second period. At last update from St. Cloud, 1-0 lead for the Huskies over the Bulldogs. That is the number 5 seed Bulldogs against the number 4 seed Huskies from St. Cloud this weekend. And then you got Omaha and North Dakota on the ice tonight from Baxter Arena, but I don't believe they are having any stats come out of that game at the moment. I'm not seeing any score from that game. I believe their stats program is down. I think I heard a little bit of rumblings about that in Omaha, so I will try to maybe check Twitter here real quick to see what the score is in that game. That's a big time matchup as well. You get the 6 seed North Dakota Fighting Hawks visiting the 3 seed Omaha this weekend. So I'm looking at the Omaha Hockey Twitter right now, and it looks like the Mavericks are up 2-0 in that game. They scored the second goal with 12:58 to go in the second period, so that was about 30 minutes ago, it says. So I'm going to guess probably late second period with that game starting an hour before ours tonight at Baxter Arena in Omaha. So last check, and it is getting a 2-0 Maverick lead over UND, a North Dakota team that's just trying to keep their season alive, as many others are in the NCHC this weekend. And so Omaha maybe almost viewed as an underdog in that series based on the way North Dakota's been playing really well as of late. And you obviously know the history of how great North Dakota's been in the playoffs the last many years since the NCHC started. And so the Mavericks up 2-0 on North Dakota tonight at Baxter Arena in the other game of the NCHC quarterfinals. So you have St. Cloud up, you have Omaha up, and you have the Colorado College Tigers pulling off the upset in the first NCHC playoff game to get over with tonight. 3-1 was their final, of course, at Lawson. And so the Tigers take a 1-0 lead in that series in a surprise result from Kalamazoo. Our score here, of course, 2-1 Denver after the first. Gets you a few stats from our game in the first intermission here. Shots on goal, surprisingly closer than many maybe would have expected after the first period tonight. On paper, Denver's offense much better than the Redhawks, especially in terms of generating opportunities. We've talked about that on our broadcast all season long, but the shots on goal after the first period of play tonight, 13-10 in favor of Denver. So the Pioneers don't really have a huge lead in that advantage of category. RedHawks getting plenty of opportunities on that. That's a great sign to see. In terms of your power plays, Denver 1-for-1 on the power play tonight. The RedHawks will have some power play time left over going into the second period. About 54 seconds of a penalty that was assessed to Denver's Connor Capone late in that first period for cross-checking on Chase Pletsky. Pletsky appeared to be all right. It was kind of a dangerous hit against the boards like we talked about when the play happened. So we believe he's fine. He skated away fine and was playing some shifts there late in the first period. So I think number 28 for the RedHawks is all right. So a RedHawk power play that says it's 0-for-1 tonight, but again, they've got 54 seconds left in their first power play attempt of the night when we return for the second period. In terms of your faceoffs, Pioneers really dominating in that category tonight, 14-6. The Pioneers have won 14 faceoffs. RedHawks have won 6 in the game so far tonight. And then your blocked shots, Miami has blocked 6 shots tonight. Pioneers have blocked 3. RedHawks have had some key blocks as well during important Denver chances in the offensive zone for the Pioneers. And then, of course, penalty minutes just 2 apiece at this point through 20 minutes. Been a fairly clean game so far from Denver. So again, divide 2 goals for the Pioneers. Red Hawk tally came from PJ Fletcher, and that is where we stand in the first intermission here from Magness Arena. 2-1 Pioneer lead as we will head to the middle 20 minutes of this game in about 8 minutes or so. So take a quick break, grab a beverage, do whatever. We got an 8-minute break here on Red Hawk Radio, and then we'll come back for the action of period number 2 in this best of 3 series, game 1 of it in the NCHC quarterfinals here from Magness Arena in Denver tonight. Again, 2-1 Pioneer lead as we have about 8 minutes to go in this first intermission. So join us after that break for period number 2. Appreciate spending a part of your Friday night with us. You are listening to Miami Hockey right here on Red Hawk Radio. All right, teams are back out on the ice as we get going here for period number two from Denver, Colorado tonight. Patrick Geshan back with you from Magness Arena on the campus of Denver University. It is a 2-1 lead for the Pioneers over the Miami RedHawks tonight. As we will begin the second period momentarily in game one of our best of three quarterfinal this evening here from the Rocky Mountains. The RedHawk team that held their own in that first period against the Pioneers have won 10 straight meetings over the RedHawks coming into our game tonight. Miami got the first goal. Denver scored the next two after it. RedHawks will move right to left across your radio here in period number two of the game. And again, Miami will have 54 seconds of power play time carry over into period number two of this game. It was that minor for cross-checking against Capone. So the RedHawks will have some power play time, a decent chunk on fresh ice to start the second. Cassetti the faceoff here against Denver's Carter King. The second period underway at center ice. King wins the faceoff back to his own zone, and it's sent down the sheet by Mike Benning. 200 feet to the back of the RedHawk net. Hampus Rikos takes it over his own end, feeds right wing. Here's Cassetti. Launches a rink-wide feed that went behind his man, and Red Savage back in the RedHawk cage, where Pearson is behind it. He'll play it around the boards to Waldron here on the right wing. Feeds it up right side, Cassetti. Rink wide, left wing, Barbellini over the Pioneer line. Will weakly shove it to the near corner in Denver zone. Justin Lee gets to that puck first for the Pioneers, and he will roof it all the way down the sheet. On the far wing, back of the net, where Pearson is. 12 to go in the power play for the RedHawks. 45 seconds have gone by here in period number two. Savage, that's Red, over the Pioneer line here on the right wing. This is back to the line. That feed got caught by Ozar, and it's stolen away by Feenstra. Barbellini near circle in front, a shot, rebound in front. They keep whacking at it. And a great save there by King on two point-blank chances at the front of the net from Red Savage. Power play's over. It expired about 5 seconds ago. You had a feed from Barbellini, topped the near circle, went off a skate in the slot. Dribbled its way toward the net, where Red Savage was right there. It went right to him, the deflected puck. He had two whacks at it against the pads of the netminder in Matt Davis. And Davis held him up with both chances, maybe three chances there by Red as they see the replay now. One against the goalie, basically. And King there stands him up with the legs. Offensive zone draw for the RedHawks. One out back to center, and a dump and attempt here by Clement on a slap shot. Deflects off his stick up and out of play in the far corner. Might have been a Denver stick, number 28 maybe, of Edwards. Put the face off here on the neutralized area. Pioneer left wing closest to their blue line with 18:46 to go in the second. We're 5-on-5. 2-1 game led by Denver. Shots are 13-10 Pioneers. Pony in the dry here with Daskus. Clean win back for Denver to the near wing. Mayhew puts it up the right wing. Lorenz there couldn't get the feed, and Clint back with it in his own zone for the RedHawks. Up the right wing, Ryan Savage chips it over the Pioneer line, back in the Denver net. Davis will stop it. Miami trying to forecheck. Pioneers able to scan it out though through the middle. Here they come over the RedHawk line, the right wing. Edwards trying to feed it over. That pass never connected with Capone. Pioneers get it back though up high in the offensive zone. Edwards an off-wing wrister. From the right side, nice shoulder save by Pearson. RedHawks get it to center ice, where Ryan Savage will dump it in to the near corner of the Denver zone. Pletsky there with it, as the RedHawks grab some changes, trying to rim it around the boards to Dukovac. That feed got cut off. Back to center it goes. Pioneer sent it out off the stick of Dornbach, and will work it back in their own zone on a regroup. Dornbach's got it left wing from the RedHawk bench. Feeds middle, over the RedHawk line. Left side is Thompson with a rip there, top of the far circle and over the net. Of Pearson off the glass, back in the RedHawks zone. Cassetti with it in his own end. Kind of lost it there, and Mazzura will take it away for Denver. He'll feed it middle. Drazner with a really good block, deflected that to the end boards on a quick rest the other way. Pioneers in the offensive end. Mazur back with it behind the RedHawk net. He's going to pick it up, try the Michigan move, but Pearson shut him down to the left shoulder. Oh my. The RedHawks working out back to center. Over the Pioneer line, left wing, near side, Dukovac. The Michigan move is when a player puts the puck on the plane of their stick, back of the net, and tries to reach around the net, put it in the cage in the top corner. Never worked. Linear circle, feed in front, got tipped off the pad of Pearson on a Thompson tip there. Ludwig handled it with the right pad. And this puck pops its way back into the Pioneer zone. RedHawks strikes him long. Second period changes here. Mayhew just got blown up by Murray. On a nice hit, they won't call it. And the puck loose from him. Barbellini's got it now in his own zone. Another collision took place. Coleman shaking up at center ice as he got tied up with Lemire. Coleman's going to get up. He was holding his head. Haskins over the RedHawks line, right wing. Lemire near circle in front, looking for the Haskins tip. Went over the net. Haskins driving to the RedHawks cage. He's not happy with Coleman. And now you got a little fight going on between Murray and Haskins. The linesman gets in there and breaks it up behind the RedHawks net, and penalties will come out of this. That was a weird sequence. This game has been really clean until about the last minute or so. Stoppage here with 16:37 to go in the second in a 2-1 game. Led by Denver. In the box is Ozar. I think that's all they're going to take. They're not going to take any RedHawks players. Never mind, Murray's skating across and he's going to go. And so will Coleman. So now you have two RedHawks in the box. Murray and Coleman and one Denver player in Ozar. The officials are talking about everything here at center ice. First of all, he had the Michigan move by Mazur. Again, that's when the player is all alone behind their offensive net. They put the puck in the blade of their stick in the air. And so they're holding the puck with their stick in midair. And then they try to reach around the net and put it in the top corner. Pearson was never fooled there. He shut down that attempt. We get an announcement here from the referee. No, the ref mic's kind of quiet. They give a penalty to Denver's Owen Ozar, 2 minutes for roughing. Murray got 2 minutes for roughing against Miami, then Coleman got 2 minutes for hooking, and now they're going to review it. So they're going to review that scrum to see if anything else needs to be added. So right now, I'd assume with two RedHawks minors and one Denver minor, it would be a RedHawks power play here. We'll figure it out once they review it. Anyway, you had Mazur try that Michigan move, and then you just had a bunch of weird collisions that took place. A few of them, I believe, were incidental. The ones that caught out of the corner of my eye, they never really, no one was trying to hit someone else. They just kind of ran into each other in the middle of the ice away from the puck. But of course, people get all fired up from that. And then you had a sequence down where the play stopped at the RedHawks net on a rush by Denver, where Ozar was driving toward the net, never got the centering feed from the near half wall, and made his way toward the cage, knocked it off. He was tied up down there with a RedHawks player. Pearson's net came away from the moorings pretty heavily, and then a little shoving battle ensued between Ozar and Murray, who was deep in the zone as well. So a lot going on, and the temperature of the game was, I would say, pretty cool in the first 23 minutes of the contest so far. But now as we get past the 17-minute mark, now it's 16:37 to go in the second. The temperature kind of heats up a little bit in this game. So both referees are in the box reviewing that last sequence to see if there should be any major penalties, anything else added to the penalties they currently have. Again, it's 2 minutes to both Miami's Alex Murray and Axel Coomlin. Murray got 2 minutes there for roughing. Coomlin got 2 minutes for hooking. And then Owen Ozer in the box. Again, he got tied up with Murray near the RedHawks net after it came off. And a 2 minute minor given to Ozar for roughing. Headsets are off from our referees tonight. They are Sterling Egan and Brian Hankus. Get an announcement here from Sterling Egan. The ref mic's quiet. So they say no major penalties, nothing else added. So they just want to make sure nothing occurred that they missed in terms of rough stuff, so nothing did happen. They just give those minor penalties I discussed earlier. So again, Coomlin 2 for hooking for the RedHawks, Murray 2 for roughing, and then Ozar 2 for roughing for Denver. Yeah, the faceoff here set up to the right of Pearson. That's where they put the puck, and it is going to be a Denver power play out of this for 2 minutes. In a 2-1 game, Denver leads. This will be their second power play chance of the night. They're 1-for-1 in the power play. The Pioneers are. Devine had that power play goal to tie it in the first. Faceoff won by the RedHawks. They'll dribble it over the far half wall in their zone to our right. Denver wins the battle, though, back to the line and goes for Benning. Left point now, the puck on the stick of Thompson. Back for Benning, center point. Thought about driving it home. Wade still with it. Rister over the net to the left. Back it goes off the end boards to the right point for Devine. It'll go center point now for Benning. Left circle now with a puck is Thompson. Top of the left circle now with a puck. Dornbach back for Thompson, far corner. Dornbach gets it back to the line for Benning. It'll go left point with it. Dornbach at the line, walking in, a shot. A Rister there that went wide to the near side of the net. Clement picked it up, could not clear. Captain Dornbach. Near corner goes for a Mazer. 1:15 to go on the Denver power play. Thompson with a puck back to the Red Hawk net. Far corner now, Mazer. Working here for the Pioneers. Backhand to the line. Benning winds up for a slap shot. Pearson handled that with the right pad to the far corner. Mazer back at the line with a puck for Denver. Near circle over there for Devine. Centering feint in front, a shot, and Pearson slides over and makes a great save off the right post. Got a chance there by Dornbach. A puck deflects up and out of play with 15:33 to go in the second, 56 to go on the power play for Denver. Devine had that puck in the near corner. He went rink wide with it to the far post. A classic backdoor play and a backdoor look there to Dornbach, who held onto the puck a little bit too long. Tried to hold it and wrist shot it. Pearson had enough time to slide over and make the save with the right shoulder. If that was a one-timer, it would have been a goal in a wide open net. Back to the line it goes. Denver still the puck in the power play. Mayhew a shot, center point. Rister deflected off his own teammate stick, and Lemire up and out of play, back of the Red Hawk net. That'll stop the clock here with 15:20 to go in the second, and now 44 seconds remain in the Denver power play. You got the faceoff. Pearson's left out of our time, or out of our whistle here. You got Red Savage in the draw with Denver's Carter King. Clean win Denver. Now the Red Hawks get a little piece of that. Red Savage trying to take it off the stick of King. Now they battle for it along the near half wall. King wins it. Rips it over on the far side. The Fiend there in the Bros. Left point. Barbellini got in on him and a good defensive play that knocked the puck free. And it's sent down the sheet by Rydquist up the right wing into the Denver zone. 14:55 to go in the second, 17 to go in the Denver power play. Mayhew over the Red Hawk line, middle of the ice. Feeds it near half wall for Boehm. It'll go up near circle. Lemire, a shot there, blocked down by Drasner. Far corner goes in the Denver offensive end. King playing it near corner, Boehm. He tried to knock it back over for King. Centering pass in front, dribbling in front of the Red Hawk net, where Ryan Sabazero will pick it up, try to spin it around the glass and out, but it went out of play off the netting. The power play didn't expire there right before Red played that out of play. And so with 14:31 to go in the second, we will be 5-on-5 and have a media timeout with a faceoff in the Red Hawk zone coming after our media timeout. 2-1 the Denver lead. Red Hawks a huge kill there in the early stages of the second period with 14:31 to go in it. And you're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. T31 to go on the second. Patrick Geshan back with you high above the ice from Magness Arena. We're in Denver, Colorado tonight. 2-1 Denver lead in game one of this best of three in the NCHC quarterfinals. Appreciate spending a part of your Friday night with us here from inside Magness Arena on the campus of Denver University. Draw to the right of Ludwig Pearson out of our timeout. Joey Cassetti will take it for the Red Hawks in his own zone up against the Pioneers' Connor Capone, junior forward. Clean one back to Seti, far corner. Clement got the puck, feeds it near wing, and Moulton skates it with room out of the Red Hawk zone and will take it over the Pioneer line coast to coast. To the near corner where he centered a feed in front. They got blocked down off a Denver stick. Then back to the stick of Moulton. Red Hawks with it. Fletcher, near circle, little shot there. Capone got a piece of that to block it down. RedHawks back with a left point. Moulton rips a shot in. Getting a piece of that was the netminder Davis. Far corner goes. Dukovac works the puck for the RedHawks. Lost it though to Lee. Back to the right point it goes for Fletcher. He'll fire a shot in. They got tipped wide of the net. In front, wide open was Cassetti. Could have been dangerous. Lee clears it to center for Denver. And the RedHawks back with it in their own end. Kuhlman goes Dean to Dean to the right wing for Rehnquist. Pass middle here, Fletcher over the pioneer line, middle of the ice, fires a weak wrister in, coming over the line. Nice glove stop made by the netminder there and Matt Davis, and with 13:41 to go in the second, faceoff will go to his right in the Denver net. Wasn't a great crowd when we started the game. I thought it would be kind of light tonight, but as the game has gone on, more and more people coming here to Magness. It's not sold out by any means, but it's pretty full here. Impressive to see. This is the Pioneers' home since the 1999-2000 season. Seats about 7,000 people. I'm going to say we got a good 5,800 in here tonight. Daskus in this draw to the right of the Denver netminder and Davis for the RedHawks up against Capone. Clean one back for the RedHawks. They have to chase it in their own zone. Split the D-man. Up the right way it comes. RedHawks on the Pioneer line. Daskus got upended there by the player back in Mayhew for the Pioneers. He'll send it up right wing and Mazur will take it over the RedHawk line on the right side. Lost it though. Kuhlman, good defense. Rehnquist trying to get it out up the right wing. Kept in barely left point by Bros. Now a play to the far circle. They're trying to hit a feed there to Mazur but never connected. Daskus got in his way. He's got the puck now for the RedHawks through center ice. So over the Pioneer line they come. Ryan Savage trying to center it over for Daskus. Never connected. Pioneers numbers back up the ice. Mazur right wing. Dornbach circles back with it. Trying to backhand feed to the near side of the ice. A little centering play there. Never hooked up with his player in Mazur. But William now with it though. Right point for Denver in the offensive end. He'll play it over for Lee. And your circle. A rip there and went just wide of Pearson. He never really saw it through traffic. I could tell. Far half wall goes to the puck in the RedHawk zone. Daskus. Back of the RedHawk net for Drasner. Near corner trying to clear it up the near wing. Got stolen away, Bros. Back to line it goes. Lee a drive. Pearson handles it with a breadbasket and will make the cover. Nice bomb from the line there by the Pioneers and Pearson made the nice stop with his chest. 12:29 to go in the second. 2-1 game in favor of the hometown team in Denver, and they lead the shot count as well, 20-14. Face off to the Pearson's left. That'll be won by Red Savage. Back to Clement. He'll spin it around the boards back to center. Barbellini lays a nice hit on Lee. He'll try to work it up the left wing. Could not quite get it to King. His teammate pops out middle of the ice. Red Savage races to take it away for the RedHawks. He'll feed back Clement. Far side now is Feenster up the right wing. Pioneers chip it into their own zone where Davis will grab it here. Bowiem near corner against Barbellini. Almost won the puck in a battle, but Pioneers work it up the right wing. Here's King. Puts it over the RedHawk line on a dump in. Denver will get some changes here. Clement back of his net. Rims it around the boards on the far side. Waldron will kick this one to the middle of the ice. Playing over for Red Savage. That feed will get deflected over to Feenster instead and from center ice. Feenster will play this one in on net. Nice glove save was made there by Davis, and he'll hold on with 11:47. Two go in the second. That'll give the RedHawks an offensive zone draw here. That was a pass that was trying to go to Red Savage and instead deflected off Denver's skate, I think. And then Feenster picked it up at the center circle and ripped it toward the cage. So the draw to the right of Davis. Owen Ozar in it for Denver. RedHawks. Blake Messenberg will take it. Messenberg loses it. Ozar wins it near corner. It's sent all the way down the sheet in the icing. Rehnquist picked it up after the clearing attempt by Bennett. Caragiolo far wing for the RedHawks. Plays it near wing over the Pioneer line where Taranski trying to pick it up. Benning there won the foot race though for Denver. Able to work it up that near wing but not out. Moulton kept it in left point for the RedHawks. Gonna whistle though for a hand pass. Moulton had to go down and play that puck with his glove. I believe it deflected off his glove to his teammate along the near half wall in the offensive zone, Messenberg, and that's what got the hand pass called on the RedHawks. They're going to bring the puck here out to the neutral zone on the Denver right wing, closest to their blue line with 11:26 to go in the second. That's where the faceoff will take place in a 2-1 lead for Denver. Cassetti in the draw for the RedHawks. Pioneers representative in the faceoff is Thompson. He's going to win it. Back to his defenseman in his own zone. Left wing feed the lead. Goes far corner. Redhawks end. Moulton spins it around the boards near half wall. Fletcher takes it away there to Cassetti. Through center ice. Dumps it over the Pioneer line here on the right wing. Bending back of his own net to get it for the Pioneers. Near wing feed got out of the reach of Dornbach. Will go down the ice. That'll be an icing on Denver. A little bit out of the reach of the plane of Dornbach trying to stick his stick out to deflect it at center ice, but didn't quite have enough real estate to do that, and the faceoff will go in the Redhawk offensive zone to the right of the netminder and Davis. You have 11:02 to go on the second and a 2-1 Denver lead. Red Savage in the draw with Denver's Aiden and Thompson. Faceoffs tonight being dominated by Denver, 21-10, they're leading that battle. Redhawks win the draw, but they're going to have to take it out back to center. Waldron didn't have enough room to keep it in left point. Dumped it into the Denver zone, and Pioneers will take over and break it out. But a feed that went up the ice, deflected off the stick of, I think, a Redhawk maybe, and Murray, as that feed went down the sheet by Dornbach. Redhawks trying to regroup in their own zone, but they turn it over. Pioneers working near wing, kept in left point by Bouilliam. Near side is Drazner to the far corner now for Murray. Red Savage, the backhand up the right wing, could not get it out. Kept in there by the stick of Edwards. He'll feed it middle. A chop there that went over the net by Lorenz. On a point blank chance in front of Pearson. Work back to the near circle. Redhawks take over. Barbellini off glass, trying to go out, but cannot. But William kept it in at the right point. Drazner back of his own net for the Redhawks. Right wing feed Waldron. He'll go rink wide. Near side, Red Savage. Trying to hit Barbellini. The pass that went off his skate at the blue line. He went over the blue line before the puck made its way through. And that'll be an offside on the Redhawks here with 10:05 to go in the second and a 2-1 lead for Denver. Really good chance in front of the Redhawk net there. He had a shot that was saved by Pearson from the high slot. And then coming through trying to whack it over the cage was Lorenz for the Pioneers. This is another Ludvig Pearson-esque performance tonight. And it was from the get-go. He is standing on his head, giving up two goals, but one of them was a really fluky deflection. The other one, he had so much traffic, I don't think anyone in the world would have seen that shot that came through on the first power play goal from the Pioneers. Redhawks over the Pioneer line on the right wing. Ryan Savage will rip a wrist shot in from the far half wall. Nice glove save made by the netminder in Davis. And he will hold on. We'll get immediate timeout. 9:46 to go in period number two. Game one, NCHC quarterfinals, best of three. Denver 2, Miami 1, your score. We're back to Magness in just a moment. Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Over timeout, 9:46 to go, period number two. You got a 2-1 lead for Denver over Miami. Patrick Geshan back with you at Magness Arena here tonight. Offensive zone draw for the Redhawks in over timeout. It'll be to the left of the Denver netminder in Matt Davis. And that will be a faceoff win for the Pioneers in their own zone off the corner glass all the way down the sheet for an icing call. Faceoff was won to Benning. He took it behind his net to the near wing and lifted it down the ice. For no reason, I believe. There's nobody down the sheet looking to get a pass, and that'll go all the way down for an icing on Denver with 9:39 to go now in the second. Another faceoff coming here to the left of the Pioneer netminder. That is Matt Davis. Messenberg in the faceoff with the Pioneers. Carter King. Cleanwood King forward. Here's Devine through center over the Red Hawk line on the left wing, and a nice job by Coomlin to break up that rush. He had Brozen in it as well for the Pioneers. Right wing, Redhawks through center ice. Caringiello to Messenberg over the Pioneer line in the far corner. Bouilliam picks it up there for Denver. Far side trying to go to Mayhew. That pass never worked. Caragiolo took it over for the RedHawks. Lost it though, far circle, and King will send a missile into the RedHawk bench. That almost hit Chris Bergeron. It missed him though. He's all right. On a left wing clear, and that's going to keep the faceoff in the Denver zone with 9:13 to go in the second. In the circle to the left of Davis. Hirsch had to duck for that one. A little bit to his right as well. Glad it missed him. 21-15, the shots in favor of Denver. They win. They lead the game 2-1 over Miami with 9:13 to go in period number two. Cassini the faceoff here with Aiden Thompson. Clean one for the Pioneers, far corner. Boehm lifts it out back to center ice. Grabbed there by his teammate Dornbach up ahead. Little break to the net. Thompson on the backhand and Pearson right there to make the stop with his chest. Nice feed from in front of the Denver bench in the far wing in the neutral zone. Dornbach played it forward. Thompson caught the pass at the Red Hawk line, middle of the ice. Had a little bit of a breakaway down the sheet. He had a defenseman, though, trailing him all the way in Clement, who made some really good plays back. I'm sorry, it was Fletcher, actually, who made some nice plays back and was never a full breakaway for Thompson. But he still got a nice forehand, backhand look on Pearson, and Ludwig shut him down with a chest over on the near post. Against the left-handed Thompson. RedHawks on the faceoff in their own zone. Cassetti up the left wing, back to center. Mazur over the RedHawk line on the right wing. Near circle, got hooked up, and that's going to be a penalty. His shot went off a RedHawk stick, up and out of play, but a little bit of a hook on Mazur, who fired that. And Dukovac is going to go two for hooking. Mazur was taking that puck down the right wing. You could tell from up here his stick was hooked for about a second. And Dukovac, the one who did that on defense. Referee will call it. And Denver will go to the power play for the third time tonight. They're one for two on the power play this evening. 8:48 to go in the second. Pioneers a chance to make it a 3-1 lead. Face off to the right of Pearson. Clean win for the Pioneers. Right point to Vine, to the slot, walking down Thompson. He lost the puck though in the Red Hawk traffic. Good job there to work it free and work it out by Hampus Rydquist. Did that all by himself. Got it off Thompson's stick in the slot and sent it all the way down the sheet. Pioneers come out of their own zone of the puck. Here's Benning. Over the Red Hawk line to the left wing. Tossed it over there for Thompson. We got a whistle though. They were offside. Pioneers offside entering the zone. Thompson was a little late taking the puck over. I think Benning jumped over the line a little bit before Thompson came through with the biscuit. And with 8:24 to go in the second, 1:37 left in the power play for Denver. It's going to be a neutralized faceoff. Red Hawk right wing closest to their blue line. Ryan Savage wins it back cleanly for Moulton, and he will bank it off the boards at center into the Denver zone. Thompson got the feed from his net minor Davis. He'll scan it over the Red Hawk line on the right wing. Mazur near circle, trying to feed it middle. Red Savage picked off the feed. Barbellini will send it through center, down the sheet. We get a whistle here for a hand pass. And I think it's on Miami. That puck kind of skipped up in the air when Red took it over off his glove, and then it went over to Barbellini, and they're going to call the hand pass on the RedHawks. Going to put the faceoff here to the right of Pearson in the Miami zone. You have 1:19 to go in the power play for Denver. Red Savage wins the faceoff forward. Barbellini takes it ahead, but he got taken off his stick. Thompson down low in the far corner. Denver offensive end in front. They score! Really good pass. It was finished off by Devine, who gets the natural hat trick. I don't know who fed it over. I think it was Dornbach from the far goal line to the near wing, and Devine ripped that one home along the near post. Red Hawk defenders were caught back. And Devine has scored all three Denver goals tonight. He has the natural hat trick, and the hats are raining down inside Magness Arena. 3-1 in the power play goal for the Pioneers. Gotta get the ice crew out to pick up the hats. Jack Devine scoring goals 10, 11, and 12 on the year. 12:03 is tally came in the second period. Carter Mazur, I beg your pardon, was the one who fed it over from the far side of the ice on the Red Hawk goal line, and a beautiful one-timer finished off by Devine. along the near post. Little backdoor look. Red Hawk defenders were caught watching the puck, caught back a little bit. Of course, Barbellini almost could clear on that play, but he held the puck a little bit too long up high in the zone. Denver stole it away from him on the penalty kill there and then worked it back deep. And that's when that play formulated, when Mazur sent it rink wide to the near post for the one-time finish there on the back door by Devine. Natural hat trick, Devine. The hat's cleaned up. We're back to playing, and the Red Hawks trail by 2 goals with 7:40 left here in the second. And that got this place fired up with some more energy. Rose back in the Denver net with a puck. Ryan Savage back there trying to bulldoze and take it away. Goes to the near circle where it's picked up by King. Daskus in there as well as the battle starts to ensue along the near half wall here in the Denver zone. You get Pletsky in there digging at it. Daskus as well for the Red Hawks. Mayhew ends up with the battle win for Denver on his stick. Finder's working up the right wing, but Feenster there to take it over. He'll play it back in the Denver zone, but William is on it. Right wing feed for Lemire. He's over the Red Hawk line on the right side. Through the near circle, but a nice job by Feenster to cleanly angle him away from the net and off the puck. Dukovac, right wing Fletcher. Over the Pioneer line, one against two. Transitions to backward skating in the far circle. Then the puck was stolen away from him, and here comes Denver. Bro stole it. He took it over the line on the left wing of the offensive zone and bobbled it to the far corner where the Red Hawks are going to win the puck back. Dukovac at center will circle back in his own end. Lorenzo's there to mess him up. Goes back to the Denver line. Here's Benning. Feeds it middle where the puck is Justin Lee up the left wing. Lorenz trying to chop it forward in the offensive zone. Could not. Dukovac comes in to take it over. He'll put the puck into the Pioneer zone. Red Hawks a five-man change here in the second period with 6:20 left in it. Far side Capone taken off his stick there by Waldron. Back on the stick of Lee. He'll go rink wide to the near circle there for Benning up the right wing. The pass deflected by Lorenz to the far corner of the Red Hawks zone. Rehnquist is on it there for Miami. He's got the puck below the Red Hawk goal line up the right wing. Here comes Waldron. Two against two, maybe. Waldron over the Pioneer line. Room to skate right wing. Feeds the middle. Dukovac to the near side for Red Savage. A nice shot and a great blocker save there on the tic-tac-toe try by Davis. Far corner, Miami's still with it in their offensive end, Red Savage. Mayhew came in to try to steal the puck away from him and succeeded. He's got it now up the left wing. Mayhew's without his left glove, too, for Denver. Hands it off, Thompson over the Red Hawk line. Left side, a shot there that went off the goal post, off the crossbar, up and out of play off the stick of Brent Edwards. Great offensive chances back and forth up the ice. Red Hawks had a 2-on-2 up the sheet. We'll eventually turn into a 3-on-2. You had Waldron feeding it over. Red Savage got a shot after deflected off Dukovac's leg. And then back up the ice, Pioneers came, and a rip there by Edwards after a feed from the near wing. Rister went off the crossbar and up and out of play. 5:32 to go in the second, 3-1 Denver lead. The shots are 23-16, Pioneers lead that category. Red Hawks on the faceoff in their own zone, it's Clement. Near wing shovel feed to Taranski at the near half wall in the Red Hawks zone, banked it out to center. Quickly sent back in after Lee got the puck for Denver in the Miami end. Holton up the right wing here. Giallo's got it over the Pioneer line right side. Taken away though by Mazur off his stick. Mazur such a great offensive player, but his defense says a lot about him too, how well he can defend. Really great guy, two-way player. Messenberg through center, pokes it over the Denver line on the right wing in the far corner of the Denver zone. Devine and Taranski collide there for the puck. Denver wins it back of the stick of Mazur here at the near half wall. He'll get out the lob wedge to send this one into the Red Hawks zone through the air. Near corner, Drasner all alone to pick it up with Denver changing. Right wing feed for Ryan Savage. Pokes it off his stick. Far corner, Denver zone. Pioneers with the puck. Wrap it around out of the zone at the left point. Drasner back at his own end. A feed there to Alex Murray. He's going to have to chase it far corner in the Red Hawks zone. Near wing, Daskus at the half wall for Miami. Near wing. Still in his own end with a puck. Lifts it out to center. Back throw to Denver. Devine on the left wing over to William up ahead, Bros, left wing over the Red Hawk line. Far corner, Trazer's got the puck. Lifts it up right wing, Ryan Savage. Up for Pletsky, right wing at center. He will hand it off to Ryan Savage over the Pioneer line, left wing. Change directions toward the middle of the ice. He'll fire a shot, high slot, went off a Denver stick. Deflected heavily to the near corner, and Pletsky will grab it there, trying to rim it around the glass. Instead, it went up and out of play, not around the glass like he hoped. And we'll get a timeout here with 4:02 to go in period number two of the game. They're going to do the salsa dance cam here during the media timeout in Denver. We'll take a break. 3-1, the Pioneer lead over the Miami RedHawks. 4:02 to go, middle period. And this is Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio. Two to go in the second, 3-1 Denver lead over the Miami RedHawks. Patrick Geshan back with you from Magness Arena tonight. We're in Denver, Colorado. Game one of this best of three NCHC quarterfinal series. Draw to the right of the Denver netminder. That is Matt Davis. RedHawks offense is zone. Miami's going to lose it to the Pioneers. And Lemire will take it over the RedHawk line on the right wing. Feed it over far side for a pass that came off the stick of Haskins to the middle for Ozard. Kind of went behind him a couple feet. Pioneers will pick it up though near half wall. Haskins drives it back to the Red Hawk net. Really good steal away there by Cassetti though. He'll bank it off the boards all the way down the ice. And that'll go in the Denver zone for an icing call here with 3:37 to go in the second. Really appreciate you spending a part of your Friday night with us here on Red Hawk Radio. Though it's getting late out in the Eastern time zone. So we appreciate staying up with us in this very important playoff game for the Miami RedHawks. Trailing Denver by a 3-1 count late in the second period. Back at the left point, Williams got it for Denver. Far side, Thompson back for Williams at the circle. He'll walk it down the far half wall. Pioneer offensive end, handoff for Mazur. He'll take it left point for Denver. Spin this one off a RedHawks stick into the zone, back deeper. Dukovac takes over. He'll skate the puck over the Pioneer line on the right wing, hand it off for Cassetti. And his shot took a weird bounce off Mayhew and up and out of play over the glass on the far wing in the Denver zone where the shot came from. And that is going to be caught by a fan who was walking down the aisle and just happened to catch the puck as he was walking to his seat in one of the bottom rows. Good heads up play there. Plenty of students in the crowd tonight. They have some pretty funny signs that make fun of Miami. Some of them I can't really read. Far corner, Walder will play it toward the middle at the net. And that was a faceoff win for the RedHawks. Walder get the puck far corner after a feed from the line by Clement. Just tried a bad angle shot on the ice. From the far corner did Waldron, and Davis right there on the far post covered it up with the glove against the left pad on his body, and they'll put the face off after that stoppage to his left. Davis is left with 3:03 left in period number two. 3-1 Denver lead. Carter King and Red Savage. King wins it for the Pioneers. Far corner, and Lee will bank this one up and out of play off the glass. I think that deflected off the glass and out, if I saw that correctly, on the far side of the ice. Almost made its way into the Red Hawk bench. So we'll do it again in the far circle of the Denver zone. It'll be Carter King up against the Red Hawks, Red Savage. Clean win to the far side. Lee will bank it off the boards back to center ice. Miami's got the puck. Red Savage right wing. Trying to play it over the Pioneer line. Benning stole it from him in his own zone. Up near wing now with a puck is Carter King. He'll take it over the Red Hawk line right side. Bros with a puck in the near circle. Walks it down in the near corner. Now back to the Red Hawk net. Bros far circle. Tosses to the slot. A shot there. Rebound in front. Pearson the pad. Save. Miami's going to clear to the far circle. Another chance. Going over the net off the stick of Bros. Near half wall. Barbellini played it out back to center. Into the Denver zone on a much needed clear. Miami will try to change here. 2:19 to go in the second. And this is a rip that goes down for an icing call here off the stick of Lee, trying to connect with a player at the Red Hawk line left wing. A pass to Bros, but it went 3 feet to his right and was so fast that Bros never could catch up to it. And so with 2:15 to go on the second, the draw will go to the right of the Denver netminder in Matt Davis. Showing a kid on the Jumbotron. Now he's got a Miami sweatshirt trying to show some pride at the Red Hawks. Crowd didn't like that at all. Messenberg in the draw for the Red Hawks with Denver's Connor Capone. False start on Messenberg. They'll drop the puck. Messenberg will win it. Back to the left point, Murray. He'll fire a shot wide to the near side of the net. It popped off the end boards and is covered up there by the Denver netminder and Davis. And then he had a collision after the play. Messenberg got contacted late by a Pioneer way after the whistle. And a penalty is going to come from this. The Red Hawks will go to the power play. Messenberg going right back to the bench. He's holding his left arm. He's going to sit down on the bench, refusing any attention from Michael LeRoy, the trainer. Referee's going to get together and talk about this. All four officials. I don't know who came through and contacted Messenberg late. I think whoever did this was angry that Messenberg maybe was in the area and trying to defend their goaltender. It's going to be a two-minute minor for tripping to number 20 and Mike Bennett. That's a big-time penalty killer, too, for Denver. The puck was covered up after it went off the end boards, came back to the net. It was covered up there along the near post by Davis, and then after the whistle blew, going down was Messenberg. So Bennett came in late, must have not been able to stop, and knocked over Messenberg, I don't know. Rehnquist a shot here after a faceoff went near circle at the center point. Nice stop by Davis with the left pad. He'll cover up. 4 seconds gone by in the Red Hawk power play. So I'm going to guess it was incidental. Benning just came through and forgot to stop or couldn't stop. And Messenberg took the brunt of it. But Blake's all right. He's over on the bench. Never got any attention from the trainers. Just got shaken up. Near circle faceoff went for the Red Hawks in their offensive zone to my left. Near corner of Barbellini around the boards to the far corner for Red Savage. Poked off his stick by Mayhew. Denver trying to win it back. Below the goal line, they can't. Red Savage took it away. The puck is on the back of the Denver net. Little scrum for it. Red Savage had it for a moment, then lost it. It was taken away there by Edwards. And he flipped it all the way down the sheet into the Red Hawks zone. 1:28 to go in the power play for Miami with 1:31 to go in the second. 20 feet over the Denver line. Here comes Barbellini. Red Hawks in the offensive end. Centers it near circle. Rehnquist, far side, they score! Really good passing play there. Cassetti finished it off on the far post. And with 1:21 to go in the second, 1:13 to go in the power play, the Red Hawks cut the lead to 3-2. What a play. Puck was on the left wing at the line. Rehnquist got it. He took it down the near side of the Denver zone through the near circle, had room to skate up the left wing. Right at the bottom of the circle, slid a backdoor feed over to Cassetti, who was wide open on the far post of the Denver net, and he slid the one-timer over the outstretched left leg of Davis. Good tag team work there, and Rehnquist gets the assist on a great offensive move there by the defenseman. Cassetti gets his 10th goal of the year, 15th point. 3-2 game, but Denver leads. Mazur feeds middle, bending over the Red Hawk line on the right wing. Yet a minute to go in second period play here on this Friday night. Denver back within their own zone after the Red Hawks cannot hold possession at center. Right wing feed for Dornbach over the Red Hawk line, dances through the near circle. Feenster stolen away, pokes it out back to center. Mayhew's now on it for the Pioneers. Left wing feed in front of the Red Hawk bench for Olmstead, but he will try to get it deeper down the ice. Instead, put it into the Red Hawk bench, up the left wing. That'll put the faceoff inside the Denver zone here with 38.1 to go in the second and a 3-2 Denver lead. Joey Cassetti with a goal for the Red Hawks, 18:39 into period number two. Hampus Rehnquist gets one assist, the other to Barbellini, who was the one standing on the Denver line near wing that fed it to Rehnquist. That's what allowed him to skate down the left wing with open space and then fire the feed over on the back door for Cassetti on the right wing far post of the Denver net for the one-timer. Red Hawks win the offensive zone faceoff. Little look there by Dukovac. Got a feed from the far circle by Cassetti, but the Weak shot from the forehand of Dukovac on the ice was covered up by the right pad of Davis. And with 33.4 to go in the second, that's going to stop play here. And a 3-2 Denver lead. The shots are 25-19. Pioneers lead that category. Faceoffs continue to be dominated by Denver, 31-21 now, but the Redhawks have closed that margin. Offensive zone win for Miami. They're turning the finger down the faceoff circle as of late. Far half wall, Dukovac with 23 seconds to go in the second. Got poked off his stick back out center ice. Bolton with it in his own end for the Redhawks. Up left wing, could not hit Fletcher with a feed, and then it'll go down for an icing as PJ was reaching up trying to bat that down with a stick through midair. It was a wrist shot pass that went down the ice. Unable to connect there with the Redhawks, and the faceoff with 14.2 to go in the second will go to the right of Pearson in the Redhawk zone. It's going to feature Cassetti in the circle for Miami with Denver's Aina Thompson from Fort Collins, Colorado. Thompson wins it back, but it splits the fence at the Denver offensive blue line in both Benning and Bowiem. And the Pioneers will dump it in on Pearson with 4 seconds to go. Mazur did that. Miami pokes it out up the far wing, and that'll be it for your second period of play tonight. So your score after 40 minutes, Denver 3, Miami 2. Shots on goal in favor of the Pioneers by a margin of 25-19. Team's legs at the ice. Got to tell you what, this Redhawks team got to be pretty darn happy with where they stand with the Pioneers here tonight. Mentioned the last time the Redhawks came here, the score was a 7-0 loss on Friday, followed by a 7-0 loss on Saturday. That was on January 13th and 14th of this year in this building, and the Redhawks did not even score a goal that weekend here at Magness in between those two games. Tonight they put up 2 to Denver's 3 after 40 minutes of play here from Magness Arena. Your second period goals. First one was scored by Denver in the frame. That's what allowed them to take a 3-1 lead tonight. Jack Devine, of course, with a hat trick this evening. He got his second power play goal tonight to complete the hat trick. The natural hat trick, really, because he scored all 3 goals consecutively. The assist on that goal that came 12:03 into the second period that made it 3-1 Denver went to Carter Mazur. He had the first assist. Casey Dornbach had the second assist for the Pioneers on that goal. Again, that's what made it 3-1 on the power play for the Pioneers. It was that, I'm not going to say questionable, but one of those you could call it or you couldn't call it. The hooking call given to Max Dukovac, the minor there in the middle part of the second period, they decided to call it, and so that's what allowed Denver to take the 3-1 lead on that power play goal, or what helped them do so. Redhawks did strike, though, of course, late here in the second period, 18:39 into it. Joey Cassetti got his 10th goal of the year on the power play. Hampus Rydquist, 1 assist, the other assist to Matthew Barbolini. And that's what made it a 3-2 game in favor of Denver. So the Redhawks able to cut that 3-1 lead in half here late in the second period of play. All right, let's check that out-of-town scoreboard. What's going on around the country tonight? Really, what's going on in the NCHC playoffs? That's what we are most interested in tonight. Mentioned one final already that occurred in Kalamazoo earlier this evening as the Colorado College Tigers beat Western Michigan tonight by a score of 3-1 in game 1 of that series from Lawson. The Tigers, the 7 seed, upset the Broncos, the 2 seed, on Lawson Ice Arena ice tonight to take a 1-0 lead in that best of 3. The Tigers shaking or turning a lot of heads in the NCHC tonight with that win over a Western Michigan team that is coming in the playoffs. Maybe not one of the top national contenders, but seriously in the conversation for a national title, Frozen Four, etc. So Western Michigan having one of the best years in their program history falls in game 1 of that NCHC quarterfinal to CC tonight, 3-1 the final in Kalamazoo. So that's a surprise. Another surprise, maybe, if you will, in Omaha tonight. 2-1 win for the Mavericks over North Dakota. That was a game we were following a little bit. Of course, in the last intermission, Omaha was up 2-0 last time I looked during the first intermission of this game. The Mavericks able to take care of the 6 seed North Dakota. Omaha, the 3 seed, 2-1 winners in game one of that series tonight from Baxter. That's a big win for the Mavericks against the North Dakota team. A lot of people were talking about thinking they could upset that series and had a really good chance of doing so. A lot of people saying that was not necessarily your typical 6-3 matchup, but the Mavericks silence all of the critics on that one and win game one of the series 2-1. So they're 1-1 away from a frozen faceoff appearance next weekend. And then, of course, in St. Cloud, that is the other game going on tonight. Looks like the Huskies are up 2-1 in that game. Let's see how much time is left. 11:39 to go in the third from the Brooks Center. 2-1 St. Cloud over Minnesota Duluth. St. Cloud is the 4 seed hosting Duluth, the 5 seed tonight from the Brooks Center. So that is the score in St. Cloud right now. 11:39 to go in the third. 2-1 the Huskies, and a nail biter there in a NCHC Minnesota battle. As St. Cloud over Duluth again, 2-1 from the Brooks Center tonight in Minnesota. So there's your out-of-town look at the scoreboard. Some interesting results tonight. Omaha takes care of business. CC the upset, and St. Cloud might pull out the win. Up 2-1 on Duluth tonight on their home ice this evening. Let's take a look at your stats for this game so far with the 40 minutes gone by in it in our second intermission. Mentioned the score, 3-2 in favor of Denver. The shots on goal, Denver is 26 to Miami's 19 tonight. In terms of your power play goals, Denver is 2-3 on the power play this evening. Miami is 1-2. Both teams take advantage of the power play so far tonight. That is one thing that both teams had very different maybe views on, you could say, coming into the game tonight. Redhawks power play that was last in the NCHC, only converting on about 15% of their attempts this year. Coming into the game tonight on the power play, it's been a really anemic power play for the Redhawks this season, so they strike and they are 1-2 on the power play tonight. Pioneers are 2-3 on the power play this evening. They've got 2 goals on the man advantage here today inside Magness Arena. In terms of your faceoffs, we've been talking about that throughout the game. The faceoff wins for the Pioneers. They lead that category by a 33-21 margin. Of course, a Miami team that has not been very strong in the faceoff circle at all as we've gone throughout the season, but a Denver team that's been very talented in that area. The Pioneers take advantage of their 33-21 faceoff advantage in this game. Redhawks have blocked 8 shots, 2 of the Pioneers, 7 so far through 40 minutes, and then your penalty minutes, the Redhawks have collected 8 of those tonight. Pioneers have committed 6 penalty minutes in our game this evening. So again, your leading scorer in the game is Jack Devine. He's got that hat trick, 3 goals for 3 points. He has 4 shots on goal. That's tied for the Denver team lead. A multi-point game tonight for no Redhawks. I'm sorry, I thought I saw a multi-point game. Nobody's got a multi-point game tonight for Miami, but you do have the goal scorers in Fletcher and Cassetti. They are the two people who have lit the lamp tonight for Miami and for their 2 goals. Fletcher came in the first, under 4 minutes in, and then Cassetti late in that second period on the power play, of course, to make it a 3-2 game. Your shots leader tonight is Cassetti for Miami. He has 4 shots on goal in this game through 40 minutes of play from Magness Arena. All right, so we'll take another break here, about 8 minutes or so, and then your third period call will be coming up in after that timeout, after that break here for the second intermission. Denver 3, Miami 2. It should be a really good third period of play. If you want to stay up late with us, as the Redhawks looking to search for maybe an upset here, the 8-1 matchup in the NCHC quarterfinals. Of course, we have seen that before if you have followed Miami hockey for an extended period of time. Redhawks, one of the early years of the NCHC, was able to sweep St. Cloud on the road as the 8th seed in a best of 3 series. I believe that was 2014 or 2013, one of the first 2 years of the league. Have to look at that, but it has been done before, and it's been done before by the Redhawks. So certainly not over yet. Certainly could go Denver's way in a hurry in the third period. We know how talented they are, but it should be a good third period, and a period that the Redhawks will look to compete in as they trail Denver by a score of 3-2 here after your second period of play. So again, 8 minutes or so, and then we're back with period number 3. Hang with us, stay with us, and thank you so much for listening tonight to Miami Hockey on Redhawk Radio. Back in a moment. All right, here we go. Period number three from Denver about to get underway. And a 3-2 lead for the Pioneers here from Magness Arena tonight. Pioneers trying to take care of the RedHawks in game one of this NCHC quarterfinal series, the best of three. RedHawks would like an upset though as the eighth seed against the number one seed here tonight. And shock probably the entire college hockey world if Miami were able to win this game tonight against a team that is viewed by many as the potential next national champion, and they could win two in a row. The Pioneers could if they win this year. We're able to get that far. All right, RedHawks move left to right across your radio here in period number three of our game. It'll be Red Savage in the opening faceoff against Denver's number seven in white, and that is Aiden Thompson. We are back to play. RedHawks win the faceoff, working deep into the Pioneer zone. Far half wall, Thompson picks it up, lifts it up the right wing through center ice. Kumlin back within his own zone for Miami. Stolen away though by Mazur. We're gonna whistle here for a high stick. I don't know who that was. This is on Denver. It's weird. In my opinion, the RedHawks had possession of the puck there before they blew that dead for the Denver high stick, so that would have wiped the call away, but guess not. Linesman called it back, and so the faceoff will be in the RedHawk offensive zone of the far wing to the right of the netminder in Matt Davis. You have 15 seconds gone by in period number three. It's a 3-2 Denver lead. Red Savage and Thompson the faceoff, won by the RedHawks back to the left point. Waldner get the feed from Kumlin down on the far corner. He'll work this one to the near wing in the Denver zone. Mazur picks it up, lifts it up the near wing boards, back out center ice. Benning worked it there from Dornbach over the Red Hawk line. Left wing, far circle, a bomb on the setup, the one-timer by Thompson. It went off a stick, up and out of play. Great setup there. That's what Denver's done all night, scoring their goals, get quick feeds over and one-time chances. Trick Pearson, but that time it was not successful. And so the draw to the left of Pearson here in the Red Hawk zone, a 3-2 Denver lead. 33 seconds are gone by in the third period, 19:27 to go in it. King in the faceoff for Denver with Joey Cassetti. Little tie up, King's gonna win it back though to his right point man in Mayhew, the right defenseman. He'll play it off the glass in the far corner of the Red Hawk zone. Cassetti will pick it up. Let it go there for King. Moulton comes in on him. Moulton tripped him up, and that'll be a call. Dubovac touched it up near half wall in the Red Hawk zone. That's going to be one of the easiest calls the referee's going to make all weekend. Moulton got his stick in the feed area of Denver's Carter King back to the Red Hawk net as King was carrying the puck. And Dylan Moulton will sit 2 minutes for tripping here with 19:11 to go in the third. It was a textbook trip for sure. Nothing you could do to argue with that one. And so Denver up 3-2. They've already struck twice in the power play tonight. Their power play has struck, and now eight games in a row. They will go to work for the fourth time this evening looking for a goal. Trying to double their lead back up in a 3-2 game led by the Pioneers. Face off to the right of Pearson. It's won by Denver to the left point. Benning to the near half wall. Dornbach back to the line for Benning. He's got it center point. Dornbach near circle now. Back for Benning, center point. Dornbach near corner with a puck. Gets it up at the left point there for Thompson. Back to the line for Benning. He will fire a shot. Cassetti blocked out with his left skate. Great job by Joey. Denver still with a puck near circle. Thompson back for Benning. Right point divide. Back for Benning here at the right point for the Pioneers with 30 seconds gone by in the power play. Near point now. Thompson on the left wing. Down to the near corner on the feed there to Mazur. He'll walk it up high to high slot. Mazur far circle now. Still with a puck. Circles back in the far corner. Back to the line. Benning one timer. Launched it over the net. Went off Dornbach's body in front of two, I think, and went to the near corner. Dornbach picks it up for the Pioneers. Works far circle, back to the line, Mazur. 1:05 to go on the power play for Denver. Mazur near point now with it. Center point, Benning. Down low in the near corner with a puck is a fiend there to Devine. Benning now left point for Denver. Devine center point, now Benning near circle, rink wide far side. Dornbach bobbled it. Back to the line, Benning near circle, a shot, and that was from Devine, rebound in front, it's loose to the far post, and someone stuck it away there from the Red Hawks to the far wall. A last second clear, and Pearson didn't know where the puck was when it was loose in the crease. Good chance, Denver. They still got it. Offense is on a shot. They score. Jack Devine that deflected in front, and I think he's going to get his fourth goal of the night. From the far circle on the power play with 31 seconds to go in it. The Red Hawk penalty killers were out there for over 90 seconds on that shift. They were tired. They couldn't get off. Denver kept up the pressure, kept up the possession. It was a Devine shot top of the far circle on the wrister. It deflected off something in front. And I think it was a Red Hawk defender, and it was. The stick of maybe that was number 20, Aiden Paletsky. No, it deflected off the Red Hawk in front, and that was Drasner. Went off Drasner's right skate in the net. Another fluky deflection goal cost the Red Hawks, and that's the third power play goal by Denver tonight. And Devine has scored all four of them. Third power play goal, fourth goal period by Denver tonight. Devine scored now all four. Oh, now they say Dornbach got it. I beg your pardon. That's not right. It went off the skate of Drasner, not Dornbach. Binders back up the ice in the offensive zone of the puck. In the far corner with it is Barbalini now for the Red Hawks and a steal away. So you get a 4-2 game. The Red Hawks trail 3 minutes into the second, or the third period rather. Back of the net with the puck is Denver in their own zone. Up the near wing, they roll it to Burles. He'll send this one all the way down the sheet for an icing that gets waved off. Olton won the race to it in the near corner of the Red Hawks' end. He will take it, hit the brakes, back of the Red Hawk net. Near wing feed over there for Alex Murray. Up the right wing for Daskus. Chipped into the Denver zone. That's an icing. Guess it never hit Daskus. Beg your pardon, I thought he chipped it in against the boards along the near wing. But he never did on the feed up the ice. For Moulton back in the Red Hawks zone. That'll be an icing on the Red Hawks. 16:38 to go in period number three in the faceoff to the left of Ludvig Pearson. Daskus in the draw with the Pioneers' Capone. Clean win back in the net. Murray to the near wing for Ryan Savage. He'll feed it up the right wing. Daskus over the Pioneer line left side. Far corner, Olvestad will shove him off. Back in the net with a puck now is Mazur, but he turned it over at the Red Hawk line. A feeder up the right side that Murray got, but could not keep in his own. Goes center of the ice for Pletsky. He'll fire over the Pioneer line on the right wing to the near corner of the Denver zone. Pletsky gets his own puck back on the deflection. Feeds it right point. Murray, the offensive end for the Red Hawks to my right. Pletsky, right point, shot on the ice, went off his skate to the near corner, picked up by the Pioneers and sent all the way down the sheet. Edwards there will fling this one into the Red Hawk zone, and that'll be an icing on Denver with 15:57 left in the third. Shots are 28-19 Denver. They're slowly and slowly and slowly growing their advantage in that category tonight as the second and third periods have continued on. I mentioned earlier in the game, and I forgot to go back to it, but the Red Hawks scratches tonight. One of them is Jack Olmstead, who's ill on the trip, and John Sladek is ill on the trip as well. He's a scratch. This puck trickles in after a near corner faceoff. Or a near side faceoff round of the Red Hawks. One slow shot that came from Messenberg on the ice toward the net. Easy cover was made there by Denver's Nutminder and Davis. There's a little bug going around the team, and it's caught a few of the Red Hawks here since we've got to Denver. So that's what is going around the Red Hawks team right now. And I heard Denver's doing kind of a similar thing. There's a little bug going around the Pioneer squad as well. That's impacting a few players. Benny will fire this one all the way down the sheet. That'll be an icing call after a Pioneer faceoff win in their own zone. He will send this one down the ice, trying to hit Mazur on a pass that went 3 feet to his right. 4-2 Pioneers, 15:41 to go in the third. Faceoff to the right of their netminder in Matt Davis. In front of a pretty good crowd tonight inside Magness Arena. See a few Red Hawk fans as well as you scan around. Plenty of Miami alumni in the Denver area for sure. Near corner, Cassetti after a faceoff went for the Red Hawks at the offensive zone. It was taken away by Mazur, who then lost it again. Good defensive work there by Fletcher. Dukovac trying to work the puck. Red Hawks offensive zone near half wall. Then it was taken away by him. He was outmatched. Benning stole it 3-on-2 the other way. Denver over the line on the right wing. A feed to Mazur in the slot, but a great job by Fletcher on the forecheck to break it up. Took the puck away from Dorenbach's stick from behind after he got a feed from Mazur. Pioneers work this one through center ice over the Red Hawk line. Mazur carrying the puck. Cassetti came from behind to take it away. Got help from a Feenstra hit as well. Waldron left wing playing at middle. He's over the Pioneer line here on the left side. Waldron walks it to the near circle. Down at the goal line, playing it toward the net. Nice blocker save was made there by Davis. And this one linked out to center by the Pioneers. Red Hawks regroup in their own zone as Denver getting a full five-man change. A little over 5 minutes gone by here in the third. Waldron over the Pioneer line on the right wing. The puck came off his stick. Lee took it away. Banked it off glass left wing. Ozar over the Red Hawk line to the near corner. Kumlin shoved him off the puck. Red Hawks send it around the boards near wing out of their own zone. Waldron will pick it up here and play it up the ice into the Denver zone. Ovestad let it go there for Bowiem. He played it for Lemire, who will circle back in his own end for Denver. Left wing feed Ozar over the Red Hawk line. Tipped it to the near corner. Kumlin shoves Ozar off. Now it's on the stick of Tyler Haskins. To the line, Ovestad. Far side now, Mayhew at the right point. He will circle back, walk it middle. Now near circle, Mayhew hit over there by Barbellini. Nice hit defensively, trying to knock him away from the puck. But it wasn't successful. Haskins got it there for Denver. They'll walk it to the right point, fire a weak shot in. Went wide to the near side of Pearson's net. Mayhew picks it up near corner, goes back in the net with it to Bowiem. Try to center it in front, tipped away from the stick of Lemire. Waldner with the puck for the Red Hawks up the right wing, puts it cross corner on the dump into the far side of the Denver zone. Pioneers are going to work it out from here. Left wing, it's Bros through center ice. Pletsky there trying to shove him off the puck. He was successful in doing so on a nice angle in front of the penalty boxes. The Bros work to get it back. Takes it to the offensive zone, a centering feed there, cut off by Moulton, his clearing attempt. Blocked out left point by Benning. Feed down low in the corner. Shot there that came off the stick of Bros. And a really small, tight rebound given up off the wrister by Pearson. He made the stop with his chest and covered up in front of him. And we'll get immediate timeout with 13:11 to go in period number three. Denver 4, Miami 2. The Pioneers extend the lead on that third period power play goal that they say came from Dorenbach, but I think it was Devine, and they're going to probably take a look at that and change it. Anyway, 13:11 to go in the third, 4-2 game, and this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Face-off to the right of Ludwig Pearson over timeout. 13:10 to go in the third. Face-off won by Denver in their offensive zone. Back to Mayhew. He'll rim it around the boards back in the net, where it was grabbed there by Carter King. Far half over the puck is Bowiem for Denver. Throws it through center ice into the Pioneer zone. Mayhew's back to get it for Denver. Back of his own net. Gets it to King here at center ice for the Pioneers. Races up the right wing. Dumps it over the Red Hawk line in the far corner of the Red Hawk zone. Clement first to it there, plays a near corner for Dylan Moulton. Up the near wing, the right wing pass Mayhew, let it deflect off his body and then gave it up for his teammate Bros as Denver takes away the puck. Shipped out back to center ice, and the Red Hawks quickly put it back on Mayhew's stick. Ryan Savage did that. Mayhew skates it through center over the Red Hawk line, middle of the ice. He will fire a shot wide to the far side, and the angle is there. Pearson maybe would have let that in had the puck been a few feet to the left. Red Hawks giving out their own zone with it. Ryan Savage fed it middle. Lorenz took it over there for the Pioneers for a moment and gave it up for Lee, who will shovel it into the Red Hawks zone. Drasner back of his own net. Puts it over in the far corner for Moulton. Left wing pass. Plenty of Pioneers in the area. That was turned over in a hurry. as it went to the stick there of Lorenz, and a nice hit laid on him by Dukovac. It allows Drasner to come up with a puck and dump it far corner in the Denver zone. Benning first to it, but Fletcher came in from behind to make a nice defensive play as they battle for it near corner. Penalty's going to come here. It's on Denver in that battle. Far side of the Feenster, left point, fires a shot in. Big rebound was in front there of King, or sorry, Davis, the netminder. And we get a whistle here for a penalty on Denver. That's going to come with 11:36 to go in the third. And a 4-2 game that they lead. And going to the box for the second time tonight is Benning. He got, again, in a tie-up with Fletcher. It's two for holding. You had Benning carrying the puck back to the Denver net from the far side to the near side. Fletcher came from behind, really good aggressive defense. Tied up Benning. They went to the near corner of the Denver zone, got in a battle for it. And I guess during that battle, I never saw it, but Benning held Fletcher. Referee was right there to call. His arm went up. So with 11:36 to go in the third, RedHawks go to the power play. It's a power play that's 1-for-2 tonight. It did strike earlier on in the game. And late in that second period on the Cassetti goal, Faceoff went back to the left point. Rehnquist to Rister there was blocked down by Denver traffic in front. Mazur will take it ahead to center ice and then circle back in his own end with a puck. Now he's still got it center ice. Mazur skating through all the RedHawks over the line on the left wing. He tripped up, no call. Barbellini back with it over the RedHawk line left side. Drops it back for Waldron, a 4-on-3. Waldron dancing to the net. They're trying to drive it through. A Pioneer player cleared it. Mazur now up ahead and a penalty's called here. King though on a breakaway to the net. A nice save by Pearson on the right pad. Crazy sequence up ahead. He got a delayed call on the RedHawks. But Williams got it. Up ahead for Devine. Cassetti will touch up that on the picked off pass. And there goes the RedHawk power play. Holding is called for 2 minutes. And I think they got Rehnquist. They didn't get Hampus for interference. Beg your pardon. The RedHawks hit a 4-on-3 the other way. Rehnquist was tied up with Mazur down the ice in the RedHawk zone deep when the entire RedHawk rest of their team, the entire rest of the Denver team went down the ice in a 4-on-3 the other way for the RedHawks. You still had all the way down to the other end of the ice, Rehnquist and Mazur in the RedHawk zone as Miami's 4-on-3 was trying to score on the Denver net. The RedHawks could not score on the Denver net. The puck was thrown by a Pioneer player all the way down the ice. You had Mazur tied up with Rehnquist still, this time in the neutral zone. They were kind of shoving each other up the ice, I guess. And then the referees thought that Rehnquist held up Mazur as both of them were on the ice wrestling each other as that puck came through. Mazur could have never got that breakaway pass. Rehnquist held him from the ground, held his jersey, I think, as that pass came up the ice when it was one against one. Then Mazur passed it over for King, who was up the ice quickly to get the breakaway, and then Pearson made a nice save. So, after that entire sequence, you're going to have 4-on-4 time here for a minute 19 with 10:55 to go in the third, and Denver leading this game by a score of 4-2. Faceoff to the right of the RedHawk netminder, Pearson. Dask is going to take it against Bros. Bean went back for the Pioneers. Far side, Lee will fire a shot to the near corner, deflected away. Fletcher's got it for the RedHawks. Up the near half wall, Clement goes rink wide. So again, we're 4-on-4 here for the next minute and 5 seconds. The Pioneers lead the game 4-2. Back to zone net with a puck, PJ Fletcher for the RedHawks. Rink wide, tipped off Daskis' stick. Lee's gonna pick it up for Denver, go over in the far circle with a puck. There is Bouyam. Up the right wing, Bros plays it middle. Skating through here over the RedHawk line to the left wing, Lemire. Hits the brakes along the near circle. He's gonna have an open lane to walk it toward the slot. He will do so. RedHawk will get in the lane and clog him up. Fletcher cannot clear though. Bros is right there to block down the clear and he's got it. Bros far circle, offensive zone, plays it in front, they score! A backhand shot that was finished off by Lemire. And it's 5-2, Denver with a 4-on-4 goal with 10:10 to go in the third. As Lemire and the Pioneers take advantage of the poor RedHawk puck handling in their own zone. Rose had the puck down the right wing, stayed with it. A backhand feed, a backhand saucer over the outstretched stick of Daskis. Picked up on the backhand there by Lemire and he shelled it 5-hole home on Pearson along the near post of Ludwig's net. That is a really well-earned goal by Denver. Barbalee through center over the Pioneer line here on the right wing. 4-on-4 tally against Denver, their largest lead of the night at 5-2. Just past the halfway mark of the third. You got 15 more seconds of 4-on-4 time two. Pioneers here in the middle of the ice. They'll walk it through center. Olvestad over the Red Hawk line, middle of the sheet. Near wing Edwards rips a shot over the far corner of the net. It bounces its way all the way down the sheet to the far side of the Denver zone where Davis will stop it. 4-on-4 is over. The Red Hawks now will have to kill a penalty. That's the Rehnquist penalty for the next 33 seconds. We'll have a Denver power play. Mayhew tried to drop pass for the Pioneers. That did not work. It was held back in the Denver net there by the netminder Davis. Near wing, here comes Bennett through center ice over the Red Hawk line to the left side. Left point now with a Dornbach for the Pioneers. Walks it down the near corner. Bennett, near circle of the line, walks his way toward the net. A backhand shot saved by Pearson. And this one will come all the way down the ice and a Red Hawk clear with 8 seconds to go until Rehnquist is a free man. Dornbach over the Red Hawk line on the left wing. Thompson got a feed in the near circle, ripped a shot that went off the stick of Clement over the net and out of play. Rehnquist out of the box. He is now a free man. 8:54 to go in the third. We get an immediate timeout from Magness Arena tonight. 5-2 Denver takes the lead over the Miami Red Hawks as the goal was scored here in this third period by the Pioneers. Tristan Lemire, 9:51 into the frame. Tristan Bros, the assist, and a three-goal Pioneer lead. 8:54 to go in the final frame. We're back to Magness in just a moment. Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. .54 to go in the third, 5-2 Denver lead. Patrick Geshan back with you inside Magness Arena tonight, campus of Denver University. Faceoff one in the offensive zone by the Pioneers. Lee will rip a shot to the near corner, grabbed there by Denver. And after the loose puck picked up by Edwards in the near corner of the Red Hawk zone. Clement will knock it away from him. Up the near wing with it comes Lorenz. And a whistle here for a penalty. Clement got knocked down the corner, I'm just seeing now. Away from the puck, and I think they're going to take two players. This was tied up down there with Brent Edwards, so Edwards going to go in the box, and so will Clement. I would assume we'll play 5-on-5 here. Referees announcing the call right now. They did the roughing route for these penalties. No, they gave one guy roughing, one guy holding. I beg your pardon. Let me check who got what. Assume Clement got the holding and brought down Edwards, then Edwards got the roughing, and yeah, that's the case. Edwards roughing, Clement holding. We will be 4-on-4 here for the next 2 minutes with 8:37 to go in the third. As they get tied up in the near corner of the Red Hawks hole. Red Hawks on the draw to the near circle. Rehnquist picks it up through center ice, takes it over the Pioneer line here on the left wing. Dances to the near corner, will feed a centering pass in front from below the goal line, but Barbalini could not catch it. Barbalini runs in a mazer trying to carry the puck into his own zone. It was a shot there that went over the net on the turnover by Red Savage. They went well over the net. Thompson trying to feed a middle. Coomlin breaks down the feed in the Red Hawk zone. Denver trying to score in their offensive end. Coomlin back with a loose puck near half wall of his own zone. A feed up the right wing. Red Savage tipped it back of the Denver net. We will go far side for Dornbach, near wing now Mayhew. Through center ice for Denver. Skates this one over the Red Hawk line to the right wing. Mayhew now left point with it. Plays it toward the net, and that was a block by Murray on that puck to the near corner. Dukovac now has it for the Red Hawks up the right wing. Tosses middle. Here's Feenstra left wing now. Waldron over the Pioneer line on the left side. And walk to the middle. Waldron a shot. Nice save made there by the blocker of the netminder, Davis. And Denver up the sheet. Benning over the Red Hawk line left wing. Drops it back to Vine. Back for Benning. Far circle. Rick wide to Vine. Never connected. Feenstra maybe tipped that pass away in the middle. Devine will walk it back to center ice here for Denver. Up the near wing, over the Red Hawk line on the left side. Devine near circle, backhand play over, and a shot was made there on the one-timer by Bros that was blacked down by Murray. Fletcher near corner of the puck for the Red Hawks, goes the rink wide with it. Here comes Drazer up the left wing, through center ice with a puck. Drops it back there for Fletcher, who will try to take it over the Pioneer line left wing, and will, but William got out of there for the Pioneers. He'll play it near side, Olvestad will skin it up the near wing to center. Burroughs plays it middle, but that feed was intercepted by Fletcher right at the Red Hawk line. Goes back to center, Lemire plays it back for Fletcher. Far side, Trazer with it now over the Pioneer line here on the left wing. We'll play this one back over there for the goaltender, Davis, back to the Denver net as the Red Hawks in a full five-man change. Olvestad up ahead, Lemire came with the Red Hawk line, Pletsky now the puck. As we get a penalty behind the play on the Pioneers, delayed. Ryan Savage in the shot in the slot. It was a backhand save by Davis with a glove. I did not see at all what happened behind the play, but Denver's got a guy going in the box. It's Lorenz. That puck was turned over at center ice. Pletsky started it the other way for the Red Hawks and ended up going to Ryan Savage on a feed. He had a nice backhand play in the slot on Davis, who made the glove stop over on his far post, and you got a Denver player, Lorenz, in the box. They're gonna review it. They didn't call anything, they're gonna call a penalty, but they didn't say what yet, and they're gonna go in and review the play. I don't know who he knocked down behind the play, never really saw that. Lorenz, but he knocked somebody down. I looked back and saw a Red Hawk getting up. That maybe was Waldron, but don't hold me to that. Waldron's already is over by the bench. Everybody's fine, it appears, injury-wise, but Lorenz must have held somebody up behind the play, and they're going to review it. We'll see if Lorenz should get more than a two-minute penalty. Anyway, a 5-2 lead for Denver over the Red Hawks. 6:21 to go in the third. The shot's 33-24 Pioneers. This is a game that the Red Hawks, I don't think, should be disappointed about at all in terms of their effort and execution. It's been pretty good tonight. One of the best I've seen all year in terms of how the Red Hawks have given themselves chances, taken over different aspects of the game, giving Denver a hard time, especially in the offensive zone when Miami is pressuring the Pioneers tonight. But at the end of the day, the Denver offensive zone has given the Pioneers a lot of really good bounces tonight, deflections, weird goals in on Ludvig Pearson. And the other thing that the Red Hawks are doing, they're taking a lot of penalties tonight, and that's what is allowing Denver in their lethal power play that is converting it over a quarter on the season, 25.7% on the year. And the Pioneers tonight are 3-for-5 on the power play, so they have taken advantage of all the man advantages the Red Hawks have given them. And Red Hawks aren't the best penalty kill team either at 78.1% of the year coming in. So our referees will announce the call after their review. Two for kneeing is given to Lorenz. I wish they showed a replay on the Jumbotron here. I never saw what happened. But the referees say 2 minutes for kneeing, and so the Red Hawks will get a power play here. 6:21 to go in the third. It's not over at all yet. Chance to make it a two-goal game here with some time left. 5-2 Denver lead, draw to the right of Davis in the Denver net. It'll feature the Pioneers' Connor Capone against Cassetti. Clean win, Capone back to the far corner, and Benning will rip it all the way down the sheet. Line will stop it here, back in their own net. Rehnquist will wait with the puck. Skating it out of his own zone here up the left wing over the Pioneer line rather to the far corner of the Denver zone. Lee will pick it up from there. The loose puck cleared out to center. The team in out there as well. Edwards put it over the Red Hawk line left side. And back in the net, Pearson will stop it for Miami. Spin it around the boards back to center, right back to the Pioneers. Ozar will lift it to the near corner, and Red Savage will pick it up, skate it out back to center ice. He'll drop it back, Waldron, over the Pioneer line on the right wing. Far side now, Barbellini. With the puck for the Red Hawks. This is there for Waldron. Left point now, Rehquist. Right point, Red Savage has got it, near circle. Near corner now for Barbellini, back behind the net for Red Savage with 5:23 to go in the third, a minute to go now in this Red Hawk power play. Far circle, Waldron now with a puck. Slides a feed to the center point, Rehquist. Near circle, one-timer, Red Savage. Blocked down by the stick there of Mayhew. They'll chase the loose puck to the near corner in the Denver zone. Red Hawks win the battle. Barbellini's got it. Back of the net, around the boards, the near half wall, played there by Red Savage. Near corner now, Cassetti. Back to the right point, Red Savage, now center of the point for Kuhlman. Far circle with 32 to go on the power play, Waldron. Walking off the board, sent it to the middle. A feed there that went off a skate in front, but William picks it up for Denver and will flip this one all the way down the sheet. Back of the net, Pearson for the Red Hawks in his own zone. 15 to go on the power play for Miami. Over the line on the left wing. Here comes Dukovac to the far corner. In behind the Denver net. A pass there that goes off the glass. Red Hawks hold control. Murray at the right point. Plays it near half wall. Dukovac near circle. Lee got hold of a loose puck there on a bad feed over and rims it down the ice. Lorenz is a free man. He's on the box for Denver. 4:15 to go in the third. 5-on-5. And a 5-2 Denver lead. Near wing is Ryan Savage. Puts it over the Pioneer line and back of the Denver net. Far corner bending off the glass to center. This one is grabbed by the Pioneers' Lemire. Right wing over the Red Hawk line. Here comes Lorenz. He will hit the brakes in the far circle. Lorenz with the puck. Gave it up there for Fletcher. And then Fletcher turned it over. Lemire down the far corner. 3:45 to go in this third period. Pioneers holding on to a 3-goal lead. Game one of our quarterfinals. Near corner, Moulton for the Red Hawks in his own end. Lemire shoved him over from behind. They're going to call that, too. Moulton's all right. His back was turned to Lemire, and Lemire shoved him over. Probably shouldn't have done that. Just get up close to him and tie the body up and take the puck away that way, but Lemire gave him a cross-check in the back. Two for cross-checking to Lemire. Moulton was, yeah, from behind in the back area, away from the boards. Dillon's all right, but just not a hit you make from behind. Get a media timeout anyway, so the Red Hawks go back to the power play. When we can return, they trail Denver 5-2 here from Magness tonight. 3:31 to go in the third. Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Face-off to the right of the Denver netminder, that is Matt Davis. You have 3 minutes and 31 seconds to go in this third period from Denver tonight. Red Hawks do the power play, 2 minutes for cross-checking given to Denver's Tristan Lemire. Out of our timeout, Red Hawks start with a power play here, and they get the puck in the offensive zone, far circle. Waldron, rink wide to the right wing for Fletcher. His one-timer blocked down by Lorenz. Fletcher able to get it back, the loose puck. In front, they work it. Waldron there, and got the feed, but popped off his stick, and they'll chase to the far half wall. Red Savage goes back to the left point. A drive there by Rehquist. Dribbling its way wide to the near side of the net. Fletcher's got it for the Red Hawks. Back to the right point for Red Savage. Tosses middle now for Rehquist. Far circle with it, here's Wallner. Walks it up left point, right side now Fletcher at the circle. Center point now Wallner with the puck. Redhawks have 1:13 to go on the power play. Rehquist center point, near wing Fletcher now in the circle with it. Rink wide saucer, left side Wallner working in front, a shot there along the near post. Barbellini missed the one-time attempt, it would have been a goal. Redhawks still with the puck. Waldron centers it in front. Backhand play. Goes behind the shoulder of the netminder, but away from the net to the far corner. On a backhand shot there by Cassetti in front. Pioneers still can't clear, but a long shift for their PK. 45 to go on the power play. Fletcher rink wide. Over on the left side now, Waldron. To the middle for Red Savage. Fletcher, a one-timer near circle. Nice bump stop there by Davis. Over on the far corner goes. Waldron back to the line for Rehquist. He'll hold on, fired in. Nice pad save was made there by the netminder, the left pad of Davis. Puck goes to the near corner. Redhawks still with it. Denver's penalty kill's been out there all 2 minutes so far. Or 20 seconds to go on the power play. Fletcher a bomb right side. Ozark blocked in with his whole body. Fletcher rink wide, a one-timer there. Nice save by Davis with the right leg from the far circle by Waldron. A puck goes off the end boards, covered up there by Davis. And with 9 seconds to go on the power play, a much needed whistle for the Denver penalty kill. 1:40 left in the third, and a 5-2 Denver lead. That was a Red Hawk power play that pressed and pressed and pressed there for about a minute 50 straight. And the Denver penalty kill the entire time was blocking shots. Davis was making excellent saves, reaching out, playing great goaltending position fundamentals. And the Pioneers penalty kill, although they were tired, they did not show it. We have a timeout call here after this whistle. Lead by Chris Bergeron, it would make sense. I think David Carl called it. And honestly, it would make more sense for him to call than the Denver bench with this penalty kill out there for so long. They just announced a scoring change in that fourth Denver goal, the one I talked about earlier if you were with us. They thought Jack Devine should have gotten it. Instead, they gave it to Dornbach. It did not deflect off Dornbach on that shot toward the net. Devine instead shot it and went off Robbie Terrazer of Miami, and so therefore the goal will go to Devine, and so now it's officially a four-goal night for Denver's Jack Devine. And it really has been kind of quiet for Denver standards on offense this season. Devine's 10th, 11th, and 12th goals of the year to get him the hat trick, and then he scored his 13th of the year on that goal that made it 4-2 Denver. That was back in the second period. They announced a scoring change on that. 5-2, the Pioneers lead it. 1:40 left in the third after the Denver timeout. Redhawks have 7 seconds of power play time left. They win the faceoff in the far circle. The offense is own Rehquist. Left point went right point to Fletcher. And his one-timer there was saved and gobbled up on a stop by Davis. He had a glove save on it, knocked it out of midair. 1:36 to go in the third. 5-2 Denver lead over Miami. Fletcher, a good look there at the top of the near circle. Redhawks won the puck back to the right point. Fletcher, left point, Rehquist. The drive there, get blocked down by Haskins. Power play's over for the Redhawks. 5-on-5, less than 90 seconds to go in the game. Far half wall, Waldron back to the line, Rehquist. Right point, Fletcher. Far side, Rehquist, left point, center point, rips a wrist her in, a laser beam there that's loved up by Davis through traffic. And Rehquist slams his stick in frustration at the blue line where the shot came from. I understand. 1:17 to go in the third. The Redhawks have now just pulled Ludwig Pearson. Empty net Miami down by three with 1:17 to go in the third period. Draw to the right of the Denver netminder. That is Matt Davis. Daskus in the draw with Capone. Clean win, Capone back behind the Denver net. They know it. The net is empty. Lee banks it off the glass. They chop it back to center. Capone over the Red Hawk line, left wing, racing toward the net, and he will score from the near circle on a wrister. 1:07 to go in the third. Denver extends the lead to 6-2. Good job by the Pioneers, knowing that net was empty. They won the faceoff, got it up the near wing. Lee banked it off the glass. Ended up on a stick of Capone, took it over the Red Hawk line to the near circle around Axel Kumlin and ripped the wrister in top right corner. And this place pretty happy right now. 1:07 to go in the third, 4-goal Denver lead. Red Hawks on the puck over the Pioneer line on the right wing after the center ice faceoff. Caragiale back to the line, Clement, he coughed it up. Pioneers rest of the way, maybe a 2-on-1. Lorenzo, the Red Hawk line, left wing, centers it in front, and Haskins there, who had a man on him. Taranski popped the tip over the net. The centering feed over. 43 to go in the third. Trasher over the Pioneer line on the right wing, playing in middle. Moulton there could not catch the feed. It was too far in front of him. Back of the net, it goes Olmstead in a tie-up battle there with Caragiale. Moulton a shot far circle, had a nice look. Good right pad was made, right pad save was made there by Davis. Wilson over the Pioneer line here on the right side. And locked up goal by Haskins against the boards, but William will lift this one out to center. Breakaway chance, Lemire to the net, wraps it around, but he blew a tire back of the net. And a breakaway decided to wrap it around. Mayhew up the left wing into the Denver zone. Near corner is Drasner. Three to go in the third, that's gonna wrap it up. Game one of the best of three goes to the Denver Pioneers in the NCHC quarterfinal. The series, Denver 1, Miami nothing, after night one of this playoff affair here in Denver this weekend. 6-2 your final on this Friday night. Pioneers take care of business and do so fairly handily with a great late game effort. Denver ends up winning the shots lead 34-31 tonight. At the end of the day, if you're a Miami hockey fan, you can't really be too upset with the way your team played tonight. At the end of the day, the factors it came down to were the Red Hawks gave Denver way too many chances on the power play by taking 5 minor penalties tonight. Denver scored on 3 of them. The Red Hawks were out-competed pretty well in the faceoff circle. That played a factor tonight. And the other part of it was Denver got some really good bounces in the offensive end, but worked hard to get those bounces too. And they played some good Denver hockey, rough and tough in the offensive zone, win the physical battles, find the passing lanes, get pucks to the net, and get them there quickly, and that's what the Denver Pioneers do so well on offense. They did it textbook tonight to win the game 6-2 over the Miami RedHawks. And we will have game two tomorrow here at Magness Arena. It'll be an 8 o'clock Eastern time start tomorrow, 6 o'clock Mountain Time here for Magness. Pioneers take care of business tonight. Now their home ice as they exit their home ice to plenty of cheers and applause from their hometown crowd this evening. And a well-deserved effort as well by the Pioneers tonight. Final numbers tonight from your game. The shots on goal again were won by Denver, 34-32 now the final count in that department for the Pioneers. In terms of your power plays, Red Hawks were 1-for-5 tonight. On the man advantage, Pioneers were 3-for-5 this evening. In terms of your faceoffs, Pioneers won that battle, 41-34 was the tally on that count tonight for Denver. Red Hawks blocked 11 shots to Denver's 12, and then your penalty minutes were even tonight at 14 apiece. Tell you what, Red Hawks didn't do a great job of limiting their penalties on Denver, neither did the Pioneers. They gave the Red Hawks 5 power play chances tonight. The difference though, the Pioneers scored 3 power play goals this evening on their 5 chances, and the Red Hawks had 1 power play goal on their 5 chances tonight. Jack Devine, the first star of the game being honored now. He had 4 goals tonight, and that is a career high for him. Scoring goals 10, 11, 12, and 13 on the year for number four, in a white tonight on his home ice for Denver. So those were your final numbers. Again, just a roundup of the NCHC scoreboard. Well, we have a minute. Mentioned that Colorado College beat Western Michigan tonight by a score of 3-1, the final there in Kalamazoo, so CC over the Broncos tonight, and that's probably the most surprising result we got in the NCHC playoffs this Friday night in game ones of the best of threes around the nation tonight. So CC 3, Broncos 1. Yeah, the game in Omaha as well. 2-1, the Mavericks beat North Dakota tonight at Baxter Arena. It is a final in St. Cloud. The Huskies beat Duluth by a score of 3-1 at the Brooks Center. And then here tonight inside Magness Arena, the Pioneers beat the RedHawks 6-2. So those are all of your NCHC scores tonight. So the Huskies winners, the Mavericks winners, the Tigers winners, and so are the Pioneers on this Friday night here from Denver, Colorado. All right, we'll do your final game scoring summary. It was a six-goal Denver night that began actually with a Red Hawk goal. P.J. Fletcher scored that for Miami. That came 3:52 into period number one. Fletcher at even strength. Got it going early for the Red Hawks. Axel Kumlin and Max Dugovac had the assists there for the Red Hawks. As just a routine shot by Fletcher from the near circle, the Red Hawk offensive zone, that dribbled through the netminder. Davis went through him. And so he gave the Red Hawks the 1-0 lead, 3:52 into the first. Jack Devine tied it up not too far away with 7:38. Got by in the first period. He scored on the power play. That was his first of four goals tonight. Casey Dornbach and Aiden Thompson, the assist on that one, that tied it up at one. Last goal in the first period was Devine at even strength by Bros and Carter King. That came 15 minutes into the first, made a 2-1 Denver. 3-1 Denver took the lead, 12:03 into the second, as Devine got the hat trick very early on in the game. For hat trick standards, Carter Mazur and Casey Dornbach assist on that one that made a 3-1 Denver. It was a Red Hawk answer late in the second to make it 3-2 Denver. Cassetti had a power play goal, 18:39 into the second period. Hampus Rydquist, Matthew Barbellini providing the assists on that one that made it a 3-2 Denver lead over the Red Hawks. And then a third period frenzy by the Pioneers. They had three goals in that third period all by themselves. 4-2, they made the lead after a Devine fourth goal of the night on the power play. That's the one they changed in that third period, the scoring change they announced in the arena. Mike Benning had the assist on that with Aiden Thompson. 9:50 into the third, Tristan Lemire at even strength made it 5-2 Denver with an assist from Tristan Bros. And then you had 18:53 in period number three, Connor Capone with the empty net goal. Red Hawks decided to pull Ludwig Pearson late there in that third period, down by three with about a minute to go. And Connor Capone, 18:53 again into the third period with about 1:07 left in the third. He had the empty netter with the one assist on that going to Tristan Lemire. So of course the leading point getter tonight and the leading goal scorer tonight was Jack Devine for Denver. He had four goals and 4 points to lead the team in both of those categories, but there was five Denver players in total who launched multi-point games tonight. Aiden Thompson had two assists for 2 points. You had two assists from Bros tonight for 2 points, two assists from Dornbach tonight for 2 points. Also a multi-point night for Lemire, who had a goal and an assist to have a two-point evening today. And that is, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Pioneers that had multi-point games tonight. Red Hawk goal scorers, Fletcher and Cassetti were your goal scorers. No Red Hawks had a multi-point game. Just the other points going on assist tonight. Kuhlman picked one up. Dukovac picked one up. Sonnen Rydquist and Barbellini tonight for the Red Hawks, all lodging points on assists in what was a 6-2 Denver win in game one of the series here tonight from Denver, Colorado. So it was a good crowd tonight. We would expect the same tomorrow. It may be the last chance the Pioneers get to play at home this year. Rest of the way for them, if they were to win tomorrow and sweep this best of three series, would be, of course, neutral site games in the Frozen Faceoff in St. Paul, and you go to the NCAA tournament after that. And then the Frozen Four, if the Pioneers are lucky enough to make it that far yet again after winning the national title last year. We will see. It's a Denver team that certainly has shown, at least in their games that we've seen against Miami this year, that they are very, very, very capable of repeating as national champions. Came in as the third-ranked team in the nation this week, the number one seed in the best league in the nation, the NCHC, and so Denver team that certainly could go back-to-back on the national stage this year. So our game tomorrow will be at 6 o'clock Mountain Time. It'll be 8 o'clock on the Eastern Time Zone tomorrow for game two of this best of three series that Denver now leads 1-0. We'll be on the air a little before 8 o'clock Eastern Time tomorrow, So join us on your Saturday night for game two, and the RedHawks going to have to win tomorrow if they want to continue their season at least one more day in a Sunday, which would be the divisive rubber match and game three of the series. But Miami's going to have to win tomorrow to get that far, and a win tomorrow for the RedHawks to keep their season going here in 2022-23 will be mandatory. All right, so that is the scoop tonight from Denver. 6-2, the final. Pioneers win it over the RedHawks. Really appreciate you tuning in tonight. Thank you so much. Wherever you listen from, we had a lot of listeners tonight. I was very impressed. So thank you so much for your support of our broadcast here on RedHawk Radio. Can't thank you enough for that. Plenty of listeners tonight to tune into this playoff matchup. Hope you come back and join us tomorrow around 8 o'clock Eastern Time, a little bit before that, probably 7:55 or so, for your next game of the series, which comes tomorrow in game two of this best of three, 6-2 Denver over Miami here tonight from Magness Arena. So until tomorrow, here from Denver, again around 8 o'clock Eastern Time, Patrick Geshan saying so long good night from Magness. 6-2 your final. Denver takes the 1-0 lead in this best of three series, and we will see you tomorrow night. So for everyone else that makes it possible behind the scenes, Patrick Geshan saying so long good night here from Magness Arena in Denver, as the Pioneers win it by 4 goals, and they're 1-1 away from the Frozen Faceoff in St. Paul next weekend. Rock's going to have to win tomorrow to keep their season alive. And until then, Patrick Geshan, so long good night from Denver tonight, and a 6-2 win for the Pioneers. Have a great night, everybody, and we will see you tomorrow.